So we are here in London for a very special, very international, very far from home episode of Comic Book Shopping. I'm so excited. Here for Comic Book Shopping, our first ever international episode, and I'm here with Mysterio himself, Jake Gyllenhaal.
What's going on?
How you doing, man?
So good. It's just the beginning of the absurd things I've done in my career. Cosmic energy flavor.
Cosmic energy flavor.
Love it.
Are you ready to do some comic book shopping?
Totally.
Let's get some comics.
All right.
Monday and it's Collider Live and we're back in studio, everybody. So it is a full crew here today. It is, or we have, whatever the fuck. Speaking more, first of all, the man, the myth, the legend, the wild of the man, Mr. McCougar. Hello, Mr. McCougar.
Hey, how are you, buddy?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
What are we in today?
Good luck. Fantastic.
Ready to do some fucking shit?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. Mark Riley.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Roxy of the Striarist.
The very true.
The very true.
You know what I never just, I just put together right now?
That her name is Roxy Stryer?
No, yeah. Stryer. Shire. Like
the Stryer Wolf.
Like of the Roxy of the Stryer.
Yeah. You could have been the manager of the Shire Wolves and been the Stryer Wolf.
I really appreciate the Shire Wolves. I do.
Yeah.
So.
But also, like, Roxy is short like a hobbit, so she could be from the Shire.
Coming in hot.
You don't look like a hobbit, obviously.
I hear what you're saying.
Do you have hairy feet?
I think it could have been phrased nicer, but I
mean, you're little like a hobbit, but you're pretty like an elf.
It could just...
I would take a piece of...
There we go. Yeah. There we go.
It got worse before it got better.
You're nice like a
wizard? Wrap it up.
Pretty
you're like
an
a hobbit.
You know what you are?
And an elf.
Pretty like an elf.
What? No, but aren't all the elves, like, gorgeous in Lord of the Rings?
Yeah.
It's like, it's Liv Tyler.
Yeah, Evangeline Lilly.
Yeah.
Or Kobe Smulders.
Kate Blanchett. Kobe Smulders.
Orlando Bloom. Yeah.
Come on.
Orlando Bloom. They're all gorgeous human beings.
My ears pointy, aren't you?
Definitely. I've never seen your ears because they're always behind hair.
You know, I like Aragorn. I think he's a good character, but very dickish thing that he said once.
What'd he say?
Well, Legolas is out on, and they're out on the hill, and he says to him,
they're out there having a cigarette.
They're smoking it. And he goes, hey, Legolas, what do your elf eyes see? Say eyes, asshole. He's saying elf eyes. So what are you going to call the guy out for? He knows he's an elf. He's like, hey, what do your elf eyes see? Hey, hobbit face, what do you got? Little turd.
What do your hobbit feet feel?
Yeah.
I mean, they're hairy and big. You don't have to point them out, dickhole.
That's right.
Yeah. Aragorn. Yeah. He got killed on Twitter for that.
Yeah, crushed.
That's
crushed.
Unbelievable. Yeah. It's really, I mean.
Are you upset that I called you a hobbit elf combo?
Not at all. Oh, I've been called worse. been called worse.
Yeah. You're a elf. Nope, that's not working.
I'm just going to say Aragorn should change his
elbit
things.
Elbit.
All right. Anyway, so we got Hey Alex in the booth, and Cody is doing his thing. Cody, you know, there's something I've been meaning to talk to McCougar, and I think you could probably help me out here. McCougar, you've had a problem doing. So what I would tell you is that you should really work on the. And if you're really thinking about it and you need it, you can use call upon the voice of the. Is that better for you now?
Yes. I have a funny poop story.
Did you do that?
I didn't poop in the public. So I was up. I was up in San Francisco this weekend. I was doing some stuff with Kinda Funny, and then I was hanging with my brother. And my brother has this little it's a garage, but they made part of it a guest house.
Oh yeah.
It's like a bed and a bathroom and kind of stuff.
I understand.
So I'm in there, and my little niece, she's like 2.5 now. Maybe she's 3.
She's able to poop in the public.
She is. Oh, she can whatever. She just opens the door to the chalet, and the bathroom has this like sliding door. But I figure I'm by myself back there. I didn't even close the sliding door. She comes in. She goes, "What are you doing?" I was like, "I'm pooping." She goes, "You poop a lot." I was like, "I mean, it's healthy to poop a lot." She goes, "My dad says poop a lot."
Speaking of poop a lot, if it was past this age, you can't bring it up. But the fact that my daughter's not even 2 yet, gets out of the shower. Not potty trained yet.
Yeah.
So wife lets her run around, which is always a disaster.
Totally.
You never know what's going to happen. She pissed on the rug. Yeah, many times, right? But yesterday I'm with the mother-in-law, and the mother-in-law's helping folding the laundry, and I'm just sitting there listening to a podcast, and I hear, I think she might have pooped. And you think? I think a rhinoceros just came in here because there was a log, and she looked over, the little one like, I don't think I should have been done doing that. Like it wasn't like a dog like doing, you know, propping up and like and just letting it rip. It was like it slipped out, but yeah. It was like it literally looked like an elephant just said, "This is where I'm going to go."
Wait, right. I don't quite understand. When your kid is running around, she just poops.
Not normally, but it just happened last night.
It can happen.
She was in the middle of a run.
Does she usually wear a diaper?
Yeah, she was just popped out of the shower. She was getting ready for the shower or the bath. So she had just so she was running around the house, like, getting really excited, and then it was just like, I think she pooped, and I go, I think you're right.
Now they're checking the column of rocks. Who's confused by that? That happens.
Well, it's kind
of
like a dog.
Yeah,
that's totally. What it said. It said it was like it was. Well,
it's the point of potty training.
But the difference is the dog goes, okay, wait a minute, this is where I'm going, right here. The kid was running, goes, oh, I don't think that was supposed to happen.
Yeah, right.
So yeah,
that was running shit.
Because she can talk.
Yeah, she said poo poo. She knew that something was wrong.
I feel like if you can talk, you shouldn't be pooping yourself unless you're
Snyder. There's a lot that you think about children that we have to have. You are a doula, so
you have been approved by the Doula Association of America as the ability to duel.
The birth is going to be in the next 3 days, we think.
Really?
You think?
And you're going to duel?
And I'm going to duel.
And you're here? Should you be with your.
It's the guy. It's the guy. It's basically
just a friend.
How are you feeling? Great. Okay, I did my job for today.
Well, no, his mother-in-law's in town. He's not doing so well.
So you're more of a therapist than you are a doula.
I'm a pretty good therapist.
Okay, therapist, though.
I can
not
see
doula.
That.
He called me a doula.
Yeah, he's wrong.
It's not a good time to tell him that.
No, probably not. Afterwards, it's all over going, I just want to let you know that I was your therapist, not your doula.
And happy to be.
Right.
I sent him a screenshot because somebody in the Facebook group made one of those memes of me saying that I'm an amazing doula or whatever, and I sent it to him. So we talked about it on the show. He was like, cool. I'm a little busy right now.
Right. Totally official.
Yep. Thanks for bringing that up.
What else is official is I watched, guess what I watched last night? Nothing. I went to bed at 9 o'clock.
Really?
I was tired. But the night before, I actually watched an episode of Fleabag.
Yeah.
And it was so funny when I was watching the show, I came out of the first episode like you.
Yeah.
My wife came out of the first episode like you did. Mm. But my wife is very different than you are when it comes to TV because the first episode, she's done. She goes, I don't like her. I can't stand the fact that she's talking to the screen.
Can see
I'm out. She's like, do you like it? And I'm like, I do. I think it's intriguing. She's like, you just like it because everyone else thinks you like it just because it's popular.
I go,
no, I like it because it's interesting. The girl's an asshole, hence called Fleabag instead of Dirtbag.
Right.
God, that's what I get all the time. Yeah. If I like something and it's popular.
Right. Yeah. You just like it because everyone else likes it. Well, I was like, what am I, a Fleabag shill now?
Yeah.
Well, the funny thing in our house, too, so we were trying to watch something because Amanda just finished the rewatch of Game of Thrones, and she has an empty hole in her life like all of us did when Game of Thrones were over, right? So there's
that was pretty quick.
Yeah, she flew through it. Yeah, she can consume if she needs to.
That's a good one
to
fly through.
The whole series?
The whole series.
Did she like
took
it?
Her, like, took her like 3 weeks. Yeah. Oh, she loved it. She freaked out for it.
Okay.
So we started, I was like, all right, so there's this show. She's like, we started Parks and Rec, and she watches a few episodes here and there, and she really likes Parks and Rec, so she's never seen an episode.
You told her the first six episodes were not.
Of Parks and Rec?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're not the best. Okay. Yeah. And it gets way better. So then we tried to watch this show, Jet, that just came out on Cinemax, Carla Gugino.
Yeah, I see billboards for that everywhere.
Three episodes in.
Is she top 10 sexiest women on the planet?
In this movie, in this show? She's so sexy, and in this show, she definitely is. Yeah,
I would
definitely.
Say I would say top 10.
She's really beautiful. But, I've never heard a guy say that before, or a girl.
She's. I mean, I think I first fell in love with her in
the Bon Jovi video.
Bon Jovi video. Oh, yeah, Jesus Christ.
That's the first time that
holy
got me.
Moly.
And then Son-in-Law.
Oh, Son-in-Law. Yeah.
Everything she's in, she's
awesome.
Yeah.
Well, she plays like a super sexy thief in Jet.
I'm in.
Right. So we watched the pilot. Amanda was bored.
As
I loved
most
it.
Thieves are.
Yes, correct.
Super sexy.
Super sexy thief.
Like an elf. It's kind of.
Stealing hearts.
Super sexy thief elf. A thelf. So, so we watched the first
not
episode.
Not to be confused with a snark.
No, a snark. It's
snart.
Snart. Yeah. A snark is a sneezing shark.
Right.
We all know that.
We knew that. Do you hear about that sneezing shark in Detroit?
Detroit.
Which came out of nowhere.
Into the Flint River.
No one knew that was going to be there. His name was Snarko?
Land shark.
You found it.
You got there.
It took a while.
Snarko.
And then in my head, the little elves are going, brilliant. He did it. We're still
punch it. Put it through.
We're still in business.
Snarko.
Sign it.
Coming out in 2020, Snarko.
It's the it's the sneezing version of Narcos.
The writer's room is in trouble, but they found a route. It was making a left, then a right, but they got there.
Get us Carla Gugino. She's Snarko.
She's Snarko. Oh, she plays Snarka.
My favorite thing.
Yeah.
Right, rock. So you guys started watching it.
So we started watching Jet. Didn't like it. Then I go, David Griffin recommended this show. Farts, what was it called? It's like another one on Cinemax. Oh, Warrior, right? We play the first 10 minutes and it's like Bruce Lee. It's like Peaky Blinders meets Seven Samurai. So it's like England, but ninjas. And it's not ninjas. It's like the guy from Banshee. Anyway, she did not like that one. So then I was like, oh, David Griffin recommended this show. Goes, no more Griffins.
No more Griffins. Keep running into D. Griff.
I heard he was telling you guys at the Spider-Man
thing,
right?
Spider-Man. I saw him way over. I wanted to say hi.
But
yeah.
I saw him. What did we see at Disney?
Oh, yeah.
We saw him at Toy Story. Yeah. And he's, again, you talk about Carlo Gugino being the sexiest on the planet. He might be the nicest on the planet.
Oh, 100%.
Are you kidding?
Just the best.
Yeah.
It's like you see him and you just feel like you run into a relative that you haven't seen in so long. He's just like, hey, he's got the big smile on your face. And you're just like, you just want to hang out with the guy.
He's great.
I didn't watch the movie.
What adjective would you guys want to be the most on the planet? What's superlative?
Likeable?
No. Most likable on the planet.
Likeable's good. Loyal? Loyal's
loyal.
Good.
Loyal.
Snarkus.
You did say sleeping first.
I would say sleeping. I would say
the most sleeping on the planet.
I'd say the most
sleepy.
The most sleepiest.
He's the sleepiest on the planet.
Sleepiest.
What about you, Shelf?
Talented.
Shelf. Talented. RJ Shelf. RJ Shelf.
RJ Shelf.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's RJ Shelf. It's gonna be a
DJ RJ Shelf.
Should be DJing all week, RJ Shelf.
What's hard about yours, Christian, is sleepiest doesn't actually mean you're sleeping. It just means you're tired all the time.
How's that, Christian Harloff? He's a nice guy.
I already am, so I don't have to play this game anymore because I'm done. I figured it out.
Sleepy.
I figured it out. I am the
living your best life.
I am the sleepiest on the planet. That works for me.
Do you think you are one of the most tired people on the planet?
On the planet, no.
Okay.
But in this room, yes.
Yeah, I mean, I'll give you that. You got two kids, 7 and 2.
I think you have reason to be the most tired on the planet. I don't know if you're more tired than me, though. You have more reason, but I think I sleep less hours than you do.
What's the average for you?
It's probably
3 or 4.
3 or 4?
A night. Yeah.
How much rest do you get, though, when you watch television, when you sit on the couch? Who bothers you? Who bothers you when you're in your house?
I no longer am able to sit and watch TV. I'm doing it either, like, at the gym or I know this is really bad driving
in the
car.
You get to go to the gym? Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah.
Just doing crunches in my living room.
Okay.
You have more reason to. I'm saying I get no sleep.
But you get to
none
rest.
Of the sleep.
But you've always kind of been an insomniac of
that's
sort.
True. That's
right?
True. Yeah. That's true.
So I'm just saying sometimes
sleeping is good.
Yeah.
Sleeping is good. It's a very good thing to do.
What time do your kids go to sleep? Christian.
It depends. So
7:38.
Yeah, Viv is off of school right now, so probably like 8:30.
Do you still have to get up and like go check on them and stuff?
Go check on them? I mean, the baby. You know,
in the middle
really
of the
baby
night.
Anymore. She's almost two. But
she's just thrown
the
bed.
She let you know. She had a bad dream last night, so she let us know. Yeah, she was, but you know, she probably goes to bed around like 7:30, and then Vivi goes 8:30.
That sounds wonderful.
Do you
wonderful.
Think that the show stresses out Cody about fatherhood? Like, honestly, Cody, do you think that
the show or me?
You.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I do.
Cody.
Right, Cody?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. Of course.
But I think it makes him feel better to know he knows more than me.
No.
Right, Cody?
Yeah, you know.
You feel decent about that.
Yeah. Well, that's. But to, yeah. And I love you to death, but that's not saying much.
I'll be your doula, Cody. Oh.
Cody, do you need a doula? Yeah.
I don't think so.
No. Okay. No. But here's
Cody's like 2 months out.
But
too.
Here's what Cody has going for him that I didn't. Because Cody, what, you're 27?
Gonna be.
Yeah. He's 27 years old.
26.
Okay. By the time the kid's born, he'll be 27.
Yeah. When's your birthday?
July 31st. Yeah.
So he'll be 20.
And your baby's due with like August 10th?
17th.
Yeah.
17th.
So we think that depending on how this one goes, there's been conversations about maybe two, maybe three.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
At 27, you got that kind of energy, and you'll be all right.
Yeah.
Like, again, 30, 33, 34, I think, was the first time how old I was. And I was
pretty average.
Okay for the first
right?
one.
Right?
40.
Not okay.
I'm screwed.
I love
Is
my
your
kid.
Wife younger
I'm
screwed. Than you?
Yeah. I love my kid, but it's just like I knew it was just fine because the oldest one was finally getting to sleep, and I had to worry about it. And it was like, okay.
I'm confused.
Yeah.
There's 5 years difference between your kids.
About that, yeah. 5 and a half.
And so how are you 40? How are you 33 and 40?
34 and a half and then almost 40.
Oh.
Yeah. I forgot where I was.
Math.
I forgot where I was. Math. I forget. Wow. Moving on. What's next? What do you got? thrown off.
What the fuck?
I got thrown off.
What do you want?
All right. No. You know what I saw, though?
Energy.
I saw
people.
I saw there was
Fleabag.
No, forget Fleabag.
You guys are not going to finish it?
It's all gone.
Are you going to finish it? You should finish it.
I'm going to try.
It's 12 episodes. I mean, it's only 6 hours.
I liked her very much.
She's great.
I thought she was good. She's definitely a real Fleabag, for sure. And I want to see where
she's writing
two
Bond.
Seasons, right?
Yeah, two seasons.
She's writing Bond?
Yeah, you didn't know?
No, it's awesome. Yeah. Well, I didn't know anything
and
about
it. She created Killing Eve, which is an amazing show, too.
She did, really?
Oh, yeah. Wow.
All right. I like
very, very versatile.
Very charismatic,
yes.
Even though she's an asshole in the show.
Totally. And wait to season two, it's even better.
Yeah, so the opening is great. The pilot.
The pilot, I
really
read.
Funny.
It's fantastic. It's a great
really
script.
I didn't love the opening.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I loved it. I thought it was a good way to kind of get you into it. But if you saw in the beginning, before we jump around, before we get going, Gyllenhaal was going to be in comic book movie shopping.
Comic book shopping.
Sorry.
Comic book movie shopping.
There are lots of comic book movies.
Comic book shopping, and Gyllenhaal's going to be in it. It airs tomorrow. And it's
huge.
One of the most anticipated ones so far.
Huge.
Yeah, I'm excited for it. You guys?
Yes. Yeah, I mean, I think what the coolest part, because, you know, I mean, we've had some awesome guests on there. Obviously, the late, great John Schnepp did an amazing job. And I think, Kawhi had the biggest shoes, as far as this channel goes, ever to fill.
Yeah.
Without a doubt. And he knocks it out of the park. And I think, you know, like David Harbour, the David Harbour episode, I really, really enjoyed. I think he's great.
Then you have Zachary Levi.
Zachary Levi was really good.
Kawhi's just so likable.
Yeah.
You know, and he's able to, he's approachable, and the celebrities enjoy talking to him.
Totally.
And he's so knowledgeable.
Yes. Oh, my God. Yeah. It's on a different level.
Holy crap.
Yes, and in a way that doesn't make you feel stupid.
No.
In a way that it's
He's so excited to talk to you, whatever your knowledge level
is. Right, and if you have no knowledge in comic books, he wants to teach you in a way that it's like, no, it can be fun for everybody.
Yeah.
And that's kind of what the big man had, too. You know, it is what the big man had.
Do you remember when we did those Avengers Endgame, like Who Lives, Who Dies videos, like that whole leading up to Avengers Endgame kind of a thing? So I went in after Kawhi, and I was just like, Benny, Carl.
And the Jets.
Yeah, correct, right? So I finished, and Thad was like, your and Koi's interview was very different.
Yeah.
Because Kawhi went on for like 40 minutes. I was like, was it 10 minutes? I got nothing.
Kawhi is one of those guys, and I say this the best, lovingly, he can talk about anything for 6 hours.
Yes.
Like after we're done, he'll talk to you, he'll talk to whoever you're talking to, and he'll be there for a week. But Kawhi, we got to take him away. And I say, oh, yeah, absolutely. Because he just likes to talk to people.
Totally. Have you guys played him or seen him on movie or TV fights ever?
I've seen him on movie fights. He's really
good.
In
the speed round, it is like...
I bet.
I didn't know somebody could make that many words.
Yeah.
He's insane.
Well, he's a freestyle rapper too, isn't he? I thought he was. I just know he's really, you know, he's a big
that's
hip-hop
epic
guy.
And we've got
okay,
it.
Hold
he's
on
got to
quick.
Do nerd
yeah.
rap.
Listen,
Cody,
I don't know if it's true.
Cody,
true.
Real quick. Yeah. If somebody out there can text or email Kawhi, are you a battle rapper or a freestyle rapper? If he is, please have him call into the show. We can help promote the comic book shopping and freestyle rap for us.
Yeah, real question for you, just because what's the difference?
Freestyle or battle rap? I don't know. I mean, you're battling somebody.
Well, but you also don't.
But
you can
do freestyles battle or do they?
Yeah.
They do both.
Okay.
But you can also write without the battle rap. You can also there are some versions where you can just write it,
you
go
wrote
into it.
It.
But the freestyle is like you come up with it on the spot.
Oh, when you're battle rapping, you could have written it before.
There's two different versions
totally.
Of it too. But there's mostly freestyle rap.
At the end of 8 Mile, he wrote it.
Yeah.
You're right. You're so right.
No, the end of 8 Mile. Oh yeah. Right.
You went to Clanbrook. That's a private school.
Well, but he had ideas of what he was going to say.
Yes. Then he freestyled off of that.
Yeah, it's still supposed to be freestyle.
Totally.
Yeah.
We're all on the same 8 Mile page.
Yes. Something that a lot of people weren't on the same page over the weekend. You know, we've talked many times on the show about AEW.
Oh, I saw this.
So,
wow, there are so many different things you could have just said there.
But AEW is a thing. We've talked about this many times on the air. And so here's a
real quick.
Yeah.
Every time you say it, my head goes to A&W.
I did the first. Yep.
Same thing.
All Elite Wrestling.
Told me that.
But,
which is too hard to say. All Elite.
Yeah. So they didn't have a big pay per view. Last night, but it was free, and they were as they're getting closer and closer to the TV presentation that takes place in November. You know when they're going to be on Turner.
Oh,
where was it last night?
I don't remember exactly.
Did you catch it at all?
I didn't catch it, so I saw the clips.
Do they just have a website streaming now? Or?
I think that's what it is, but I mean, Satin will probably be able to tell you better about it. But I and a lot of this coverage is all over the pro wrestling sheet, so make sure you check that out. He had a lot of coverage on it. But so in the Attitude Era, which was the when you knew it was going on with Stone Cold, and during that time and during the ECW, unprotected headshots from chairs was happening all the time. Mm-hmm. It was happening often. Like there was The Rock was getting hit in the head with
you
chairs.
You showed me that video
of The Rock hitting McFoley in the head many times, and that was during that time, and it happened over and over again. One of the main things after the whole Chris Benoit thing happened, you know, they said concussions. Head damage. Besides of him just doing again hit with heads with a chair, he was flying off of the rope and banging his head into the floor all the time too.
But similar to football, they were finding that concussions were causing.
Yep, absolutely. So the WWE banned it completely, right? And it's been banned. So last night on AEW, Cody Rhodes.
So you can't hit chairs anymore in WWE
in the head.
No, yeah,
in the back you can. Similar to what we did with Andrew Guy and Bateman.
I thought that was real.
It was. So they, but anyway, so last night, Cody Rhodes, who runs this whole thing, him and Tony Khan, right, gets hit in the head, unprotected headshot, and gets a lot of slack from it. Now, here's the positives of it.
Slack from?
Flack.
Flack, by the way. Not slack. Sorry, flack.
Slack from, is
from,
an app.
Correct.
Flack from flack fans?
From fans, critics, from media, everyone. Right, it was just trending last night as far as like unprotected chair shots in 2019. Like wow, like that type of thing. The positives. People are talking about AEW more so than they were already. Another positive is that it's Cody Rhodes who runs
it's his own company. It's company. Not like he was forcing somebody else to take a headshot.
Correct.
Yeah.
He didn't ask anyone else to do it. He didn't force anybody else to do it. He did it on his own. Now,
are we allowed to show that video? Because somebody tweeted
I'm sure
it
you can pull a clip. It's on social media. It's on social media. If you take it off the social media.
They are the most strict right now, though.
Yeah, but if you went on social
just
media.
Just like on a Twitter.
Yeah,
you can find it on Instagram, probably.
Yeah. Either way, it's if you. I don't know if it's going to be.
I mean, he goes down. Does he get knocked unconscious, or is that fake?
No, he needs stitches.
Oh.
For sure.
Oh,
but
Jesus.
Can you see the actual?
Did you see it?
The shot?
Yeah, somebody tweeted it at me.
Oh. Just go on Twitter. It's on Twitter. Just go on Twitter. If you type in Cody Rhodes, and it'll probably just pop up. In general, but we'll see the chair shot was everywhere.
That guy looks like remember that dude that used to drink with us at St. Nick's.
That's the after
Neil McDonough.
There you go. Here.
I love Neil McDonough. Whoa.
So that's the overall shot, and it's like and you know again it was they also said that it might have been they did something to the chair to make but if you go back to the actual shot itself,
does
here
he have
it is.
A mullet.
So it's like yeah, and like I said, it's his company now. Do I think they should keep doing this? No, they shouldn't.
Do you think
they
were intending on continuing to do this?
Oh, it's on BR Live. That's where they're getting their money. Oh,
okay, I think they were intending for people to talk about it, like they are today.
But you don't think they were intending to have this be the new standard for their company?
No, I don't think Cody Rhodes is going to put other wrestlers in danger for doing this. I think that he knew that he was going to do this, get people talking about it. He's savvy, man. He's savvy. He's getting the word out there, and he knew he was gonna catch flack from it.
So smart or not smart that they did this? If you have to pick one, Christian.
Smart.
Okay. Mm.
I do. I understand why they're getting shit for it, and they should. They should get shit for it. But I also think he knew it was going to be coming. I think he knew it, and I don't think that they should. I think that if they keep doing it and they put other wrestlers in risk for doing it, then I think it's dumb. But I think by doing it in your company, knowing people will talk about it, selling the shot, I think that it's probably the last time that they should do it. I don't think that because you don't want to put first of all, especially running the company, you don't want to put yourself in that. But
100%.
I think it's just you did one thing. The more people are talking about AEW, so.
But do you think there's a problem that Cody Rhodes or people like Cody Rhodes think that they're invincible, think that they're untouchable, think that it can't happen to them what's happened to other people where concussions lead to behavioral issues, so that this is an actual long-term problem that he would do something like this?
I don't think that he thinks he's invincible and indestructible because if he – and I say that after last night's thing or whenever, Saturday if he continued to do it and he kept doing it, then it's another conversation that we'd probably have to have in, you know, a couple of months from now. But I think for like knowing that if he said, look, I'm going to take the shot, I'm going to take the hit. I'm going to take the hit physically. I'm going to take the hit on social media, but it's going to get people talking. And I'm going to take that for the company. And I just, because there's no way that they're going to get the support from the community, because there are a lot of people who are pushing back and saying, hey, it's his company, let him do his thing. And I'm certainly not doing that. I'm saying I understand why he did it. I don't think he necessarily needed to do it. I think they're getting enough buzz right now in general that they didn't need to do this.
Is there any chance he didn't realize that he was going to get pushback from the community?
I don't know.
With that in place, right?
I mean, with the Nick, with stitches, he still had a head injury. I mean, like, with to draw blood from chair. I mean, he's still probably a minor concussion.
No. She's asking whether or not she like
push back from the fans.
She means it. I think
like maybe he didn't think about it and was like, oh, we're just going to be the more, if WWE has all these rules, now we're taking this and we're saying, screw those rules.
We're going Attitude Era style.
Exactly. It was like those bats covered with the barbed wire back in the day. And the Lucille's of the world.
I think that certainly had something to do with it, that they're willing to go to that route. But I also think that he knows this business very well. He knows what the atmosphere is like, the culture is like right now. And he's a smart guy, and he's been around this business for a very long time. I'm sure he knew it, and I'm sure he knew people were going to talk about it.
You think the conversation behind closed doors right now is, okay, that worked?
Yeah, I think part of it is that. I think there's probably a bigger conversation in general. Like, we've got to also make sure that we have the support of everybody, too. So we did our thing. They're talking. They know that we're doing it. But, again, the main thing is, if there was been someone else except him that did it, this would be a bigger thing.
Right.
Because you can't ask your other wrestlers to do this. You
just
can't.
Do you think he should issue a statement saying that, apologizing, but saying it was me and my company?
No, I don't necessarily think he needs to, because it's his company and it was him and they did it and he was the one that was hurt, you know. No one else got hurt inside of this thing too. And it is a promotion of, they have been promoting the middle fingers and the bad language, and it is an adult oriented thing. They are going more towards that Attitude Era thing that they've been promoting. But I just think it's a dangerous road to continue to go down. But if you're going for a marketing push, I think it worked, but I think that this is not something you continue to do. I think it just puts too many people at risk. Yeah, but I don't know. I'm curious what everybody else thinks. Do you think that this is something they should bring back? If the wrestlers are into it, then let them do it. But the problem with that.
No, F that.
That's the problem, because these guys, they're warriors, and they want to keep doing, and dude, it's like, I'll take the shot, I'll take the headshot, and then you keep getting concussions and you have these problems that you had back in the league.
But it's sort of like in hockey, right? Is hockey fighting used to be way more prevalent. I mean, teams used to sacrifice roster spots for enforcers, okay? Rarely do teams do that anymore. I mean, your enforcer has to be really good at hockey now, if you do employ one, but they try and get rid of fighting as much as humanly possible. Is there still fighting in the game? Of course there is, but it's not as prevalent as it used to be, where it's just like, hey, tonight, guaranteed these two guys are going to fight.
So you got to protect your athletes.
Correct.
You got to protect your performance.
And those guys, same thing. They were killing themselves. They were getting major concussions. Yeah. They were depressed. It was a scene.
I'm not for it if it's everybody. I mean, I get it. Well, for this one-time thing, the guy who owns the company did it. He got people talking, and I get it. Not necessary, but I get it. Move on from it now. What do you think?
I think that he shouldn't have done it in general because there's other ways to get buzz.
Agreed.
And we just don't know. We're still doing research, and as people are donating their brains, it's easier to figure out. But we still don't know. Is it one massive blow? Is it continual blows? Like, what is the thing that really changes who you are and causes you to either A, just be a slightly different person, or B, to the extreme?
Benoit.
So I think that no risk is worth that. There's things in life you can't avoid, like massive car accidents, but to put that on yourself just because it's your company, I think there's better ways to get publicity.
I don't think you're wrong. Yeah.
But again, if he doesn't continue to do it, it's better than what it could be.
Right. That's a good question, too. How do they answer? Do they just not mention it at all? Just go on about what they were doing, because their last show, because I think that this event in general, I mean, again, we should probably try to have Ryan in here today for this, but I saw a lot of the reviews and didn't look like this one went off as great as the other one did. And I say this as someone who didn't watch it. I'm just looking at the reviews that I had seen. I want to know what the overall kind of consensus was from those who watched it. Did you think it was good?
I keep hearing cheap.
This one was cheap.
I've heard that from since the throne Cheap. I keep hearing cheap. It looks cheap.
Oh.
That's what I'm seeing online, at least.
That one, see, I like that one. That one to me was, I thought, that particular bit was cheap, but I thought the whole event was actually pretty awesome. It's very old school. But I don't know how this one went. I want to make sure they don't go over the top like they're trying to become ECW from back in the day in like 96 and just being extreme to get people talking because that's how people get hurt.
Yeah, ECW was...
It was crazy because it got everybody talking but people were getting hurt and that's why it was shock value, yeah. Right? But they did have good matches and great characters, and that's when Paul Heyman was running the show.
I never watched the thing. I just remember seeing the commercials of just like dudes going through tables with
barbed wire, falling off. Yeah, and that's, yeah. It was shock value, but it was also building out characters. But I think that what AEW will be able to do is what they promised as far as the overall bringing the sport element of it back and getting us good matches and good characters and trusting the wrestlers to cut their promos. And that's what they really sold it on. Stay away from like the – don't want to throw Mick Foley off the top of a cage to get people talking again because that's also how people get – really fucked up, and then you lose your company in general because you don't have the people. But I don't think that's where they're going. I think they're probably going to rely more on it. And I think this, to me, excuse me, not rely enough on the extreme headshots and all that shit. Just go back to what you promised, and you got people talking. So
one of your daughters comes to you in 10 years, 15 years, 20 years from now, whatever it is, and says to you, "This is what I want to do. I want to be a wrestler."
I'm never going to tell my kids that, you know, when they're old enough, right, that they can't do what they want to do.
Porn?
Well.
I don't think they ask his permission at that point.
Yeah, I know. And it's
just throwing out the outlier.
I know what you're saying. But, I mean, as far as, like, careers in general, that, you know.
He literally can't
thing.
Even think about it or talk about it.
I know.
It.
But as far as
when the first kid comes over for a date, I'll be there to Martin Lawrence, Will Smith in Bad Boys 2, that kid.
Right.
I'm here to pick up Vivian. Who that?
Right. Yeah. But no, I'm saying as far as the, you know, it depends. You know, it's the same thing. Like, I know people whose sons want to play football, right? And it's like they get nervous about it. And it's hard for me to say to somebody, you know, except your situation, what you just brought up, but a saying like,
what did he bring up?
Ralph's going to Ralph's and shopping at Ralph's.
You don't want them.
I don't want
them
shopping at Ralph's. Okay. I'm not a big Ralph's fan.
Bristol Farms fan.
Yeah, big Bristol Farms fan. There's no point that can be made in the show because every time you try to, you hit a brick wall.
What with the pornography thing?
No, that threw it off. There's no doubt about that.
You literally cannot even say it
because who the fuck wants their kids to be in porn?
I know. I get it. I'm just saying. I did. I threw a wrench in the system, and I apologize.
Right.
I totally snarked you.
You certainly did. You will not
I have
be
to
having...
say, I truly don't think my father would care. I have to say.
When
I,
porn?
I truly do You're not wrong. Think so.
You're wrong. You're 100% wrong. I'd never met your dad, but I know.
I was just going to say.
You're wrong.
I think your dad would have feelings.
Because the first thought is like, oh, we're just having sex. Not, oh, look at this fire hose. And here's another one. Bro, oh, wow. Looks like an ocean just hit her in the face. Yeah. It's like, no.
Yes.
No.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No.
Nope.
No.
No, thank you.
No. It's a no for me, dog.
Look at Riley.
It's true. He makes a solid.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's not just sex.
No, it's not like, oh, let's just do this like really lovely scene where it escalates to sex. It's like there's 9 dudes in here, and it's all gonna get weird.
Because
it doesn't. You can't just say like, hey, listen, this is all I'm gonna do.
Who's on set today? Tree Trunk Jim.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, Tree Trunk Jim's coming in.
Remember that we were talking about your daughters, and that's how.
That's
this
what I'm
started.
Saying. It's like no. That one I would say no.
No.
Okay.
Everything else, I think wrestling is like if you're. I think that's a pretty cool thing.
But it's still used.
Dangerous.
Know, but it's dangerous. Because WWE has made it. WWE has made it, and that's why again a lot of the John Oliver was it John Oliver.
Yes.
Report was a little off as Brad Gilmore had made. He was talking a lot of the stuff from say like the 90s and even the early 2000s. They've done significantly improvements to the wrestlers now because. Very similar to what you were talking about with how it is more like run like a company. Now people know what they're getting into. Now it's not like it was back in the day with Roddy Piper and those guys too. It is. They are still freelance. Uh-oh, what happened now?
Tree Trunk Jim.
Yeah, it's a good one.
Well, you know,
he's probably out there somewhere.
I know you were on a train of thought, but
it doesn't matter
anymore. Would you rather stripper or porn star?
Stripper.
You'd rather her be a stripper.
Neither.
Yeah. How about neither?
Yeah.
Does that work?
Nothing in the adult industry.
I
is
always
really
tell you when I give you these options, you want me to play along. You have to play along, one or the other.
Can I? All right. So can I cut you off in the middle of a thought every time that you're about to say something?
And I haven't done that.
Boom.
But listen I have. To this episode. Yeah,
I have.
I'm gonna
you
find
think
out.
It's me, but it's been Makuga.
Right, we'll it has. You're correct.
And I'm not sure, mad at it.
I'm sure, we'll get it. We'll find out in the comment section.
Well, I mean, you came in hot. You're like, I would never tell my daughter not to do something. Like, porn.
And it was fair. Fair point.
Porn?
To which the answer probably like, please don't do that.
Yeah.
Please don't embarrass the family.
Yes.
But anyway, let's move on.
Quite the conversation.
You want to embarrass yourself?
Go ahead.
What do you need? I'm going to embarrass you right now because you said something last night.
What did I say?
That was dumb. And I don't want to hear about the excuse of why you said it because I saw your excuse and it's bullshit.
Well, here's the funny part.
No.
Were you guys together?
You rarely say anything back to a tweet of mine.
And I did. Yeah. Because it annoyed me. Because you never saw it and you shouldn't put out blanket statements. He said last night in a tweet that he has never seen a Stanley Tucci movie that he has not liked. And I immediately put a picture of Merlin from the Transformers last night. And he's like, I've never seen that movie. It's like, there's a lot of the man's library that you haven't seen. So
it's true.
We've seen like six of his films.
Yeah, but he said, I've never seen something of his that I didn't
But the way that he was making it seem like he had seen so many Stanley Tucci movies. There are tons of Stanley Tucci movies out there.
10, 8 Stanley Tucci movies.
He's been asking for a Stanley Tucci slice on the Schmodown.
Do you like the Tucci?
I do. I'm a big Tucci guy.
You wake up in the morning and you go, it's time for the Tucci.
Yeah. Get a little Tucci going.
Hey, Ma, where's the Tucci?
Come on. Hey, I need a little Stanley Tucci every morning.
I want my eggs, I want my bacon, and I want my Tucci. Where's Stanley Tucci?
Welcome to the Tucci cast. I'm Stanley Tucci. Your morning Tucci.
Tucci summer camp with my friend here, and he's going to be teaching you everything about Stanley Tucci movies except The Last Night. Not going to cover that at all.
Not going to do it. That's part of his repertoire, his resume, if you will.
Now, as far as movies, we are going to teach you about the three that he likes. Everything else, nothing.
All
Easy
three Hunger Games.
Devil Wears Prada and Hunger Games
Lovely
trilogies.
Bones, fuck it.
Yep.
Not going to happen.
Oh, he's not so good in that.
He's good in it, but the movie, not too great.
I didn't love it.
It's not good subject matter.
That's right.
No. You're not big as good as the book.
You're a big fan of The Muppets Most Wanted, is you?
I didn't mind it.
You didn't see it. You're lying. Percy Jackson, Sea of Monsters? Is that another one on the top of your list?
I got to tell you, I'm a pretty big Percy Jackson fan.
Yeah, you've never seen a fucking lick of it, you lying prick. You missed the Peabody and Sherman. How many times have you seen that
one?
Not a one frame, you fuck.
You're really going deep on the Tucci.
Hey, buddy, see the Tucci?
Robots, is that another one?
I love that Tucci's robots.
What's the program?
The program with Stanley Tucci and the robots.
Robots? Oh, let's put it on the Tucci. Shall We Dance, when he played Link. Remember that one?
Oh, I loved him in Shall
that's
We
right,
Dance.
That's right.
And Shall We Watch It?
Shall We Watch the Tucci?
We should.
I'm down to watch the Tucci. How about The Alarmist? when he played Heinrich Gingross.
He hit the snooze button in The Alarmist.
That's right. You know, he was in Jury Duty, too. You
loved
know
Jury Duty.
No, you're not a big fan.
Never
of
saw the movie.
You don't like any of his fucking movies.
It's a good TED Talk. It's a great.
It's the Tucci Talk.
It's the Tucci Talk.
It's the Tucci Talk.
Jack the Giant Killer, right?
Do you know that, Stanley, too, do you know the story between he and Edie Falco?
No, tell me.
So when they were doing Frankie and Johnny on Broadway, they were both married to different people. Did the play, got married to each other. When the play ended, they got divorced.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's
quite the whirlwind.
They they fell in love on the set, and then when the play was over, they realized, like, oh, wait a second, we're not Frankie.
I loved your character.
Stanley and Edie.
Yeah. I loved your character.
How many times has that happened?
You would think they would know that.
You would think. But when you're spending, like, you know, every day rehearsing, every day performance, sometimes twice a day, there's nobody else in your life. It's kind of like when you work in a restaurant and you fall in love with a waitress and then you quit, and then you, like, quit the restaurant. You're like, why did I date that waitress?
Wow, his wife passed away.
When?
With breast cancer in 2009. No.
This was way before that.
Yeah,
this is like
awful. Yeah, Tucci left.
You don't hear that a lot anymore about breast cancer.
Did you say that he had an affair with Edie Falco?
Edie Falco. Yeah,
he had an affair with her. Yeah.
Yeah.
He left his wife in 2002 and had an affair with Edie Falco.
And then got married to her and then left her.
With whom he was appearing in Broadway's Terrence, but Frankie and Johnny. Yeah. But the affair ended, and then he returned to his wife and Johnny.
There you go. That's what it was. What yeah.
Jeez, man.
That's the Tucci.
That's the ending of the Tucci.
Way to wrap it up.
Yeah, it's a way to wrap it up.
Wow,
all right.
That's so sad.
Yeah, it is really sad.
I was the Miss Genesis has been sick the last couple days, and I was out of town, so we were watching. Yesterday, we were just like flipping around, and Easy A came on. And that's why I got, because Stanley Tucci in Easy A is fantastic.
You were flipping around.
Flipping around, you know, flipping on the tooch.
I thought that was a new term we were using with kids. We were flipping around.
Flipping around.
Yeah. I mean, you could use it.
Splish, splash. Splish, splash.
Correct.
I want to get you a remote that has Tooch on the back, but his arms are wrapped around and it points to the buttons.
Right here.
Wait, so
right
you guys are flipping around?
Flipping around. Easy A came on. We forgot how much energy started. That movie is great. We watched the whole thing all the way through, and he's fantastic in it. And then I tweeted out, which obviously became like people. As soon as I say one opinion about a movie, that like I think that I tweet gold sometimes, and it gets like 8 likes.
Stanley.
Yeah, and then I tweet something about a movie, and it. So I was like, Easy A is the most underrated, in my opinion. Easy A is the most underrated coming of age movie of all time. And it was like underrated. Look at this, underrated. And I was like, all right.
Yeah.
Why?
Right, film Twitter.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Calm your horses.
I won't be able to move on until I figure it out. Why did we play the Splish Splash thing and then you sang 1 week?
Because we all have that.
Because they do that clip where it just goes, it's been.
They do?
And that's it.
Yeah. It was from last week.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
No, you've been playing that for a while.
No.
It's, yeah.
Or,
it's
maybe only on
Cody, will you illuminate us?
Yeah, it's I'm pulling it up.
I've never heard that.
You've heard it. It's a Wangers.
I know the song.
Yeah, when they play it, they do it a lot.
Because we were talking about karaoke. Yes. It was part of like it's a good karaoke.
Not
song.
On Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. I'm telling you.
I think it was Thursday because I wasn't here Friday.
Well, yeah.
Either way,
it happens.
So speaking of Friday, one of the things that I wanted to tell you guys is that I forget the actual account, but Kate Mulligan. I know a lot of people were asking. She's got an account, Instagram account. Thank you.
There it is.
So she's got an Instagram account that I want you guys to follow if I can find.
Yeah, I followed.
Yeah, so it's Kate.
She's active now.
She really is.
I gotta follow
it. It's Katest Mom Ever, and she's at 295 followers. We want to get her to over 300, so that won't be very hard. So, Katest Mom Ever. Make sure that you check her out. She does a bunch of videos. So she's and we're gonna try to get Kate. Thank you so much. We're gonna try to get Kate.
Found it.
We don't have shows this week, Thursday, Friday, right? That's the.
We got to tell her though. She can't just only do videos.
Why?
Because it won't be good for her Instagram if she's only posting videos.
But what if she's just doing it just to make videos?
I don't think we'll get her a lot of followers.
Okay. Well, maybe she just wants a couple more.
Okay.
No? I mean, maybe she'll do some pictures? I don't understand.
It's been.
It's been.
What is she posting videos of?
Little comedy videos.
This is a Coca-Cola on the table.
Yeah, well, it's just little comedy videos that she was putting up.
She's the greatest.
Yeah.
Or the catest.
She's the catest.
But I'm...
So go ahead and give her a follow over there because that's she's really trying to push the comedy stuff. She's getting back into it, and we're gonna like I said, I think she's gonna try to get back into the show a couple more appearances, maybe a week. So
yeah,
look for that. And another thing, look forward to San Diego. Like we said, the tickets for the Schmodown available July 20th. TheSchmodownLive.com. I can officially announce now that the main event will be Rachel the Crusher Cushing putting the Inner Geekdom Championship on the line against Mike Kalinowski, who earned his shot against Kevin Smets at the Collision in just a incredible. What a match it was.
What a match.
Because you were here during that time,
right?
Of course. And insane.
Insane. Insane. I mean, that last question broke my heart.
It did.
Broke my heart.
Did you hear what happened in the end? So. Back and forth it was with these two. In the first round, we thought Smets was going to kind of annihilate in the first round. Mike misses his first question to start it. Smets hits his first question. Then they both start missing. Then they pick it up, and we have the match we think they're going to have. Okay. Smets.
Do you think that was nerves?
A little bit.
Okay.
I think they both. Smets hits his second round and just flies through it. Mike hits a perfect round in the second. So now we're close to getting a fucking sudden death, right?
Oh, okay.
Smets hits his two. Mike hits his two. Smets hits his three. Mike hits his three. Smets gets his five-pointer, and it's what is the last words that the goblin says to, Peter before he goes? And the answer is
Peter,
Spider-Man.
Spider.
And it's don't tell Harry.
Right.
Smets says, don't tell Peter.
But it's two. Peter.
It's to Peter. And then so
it doesn't make sense.
And he
just
doesn't realize
he brain farted because he knows he's got it. He was like, don't tell Peter.
And he's like, I got it.
Right. And then the whole audience goes,
And we look over and I said, that's incorrect. And he's like, what? And I go, it's don't tell Harry. And he goes, oh, my God. So then Mike stands up. And Mike starts circling now because he's like, I can take this and I don't go to sudden death. And the question is about Jerry Goldsmith. And it's like, how many Star Trek has he? He's on five of them. Name three. And he gets into this zone and he goes, I couldn't.
And he says it was him and Shannon's last thing they studied before walking in.
Yeah. And he goes, boom, 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 and hits it. And he goes,
He kept naming them past three too. He just kept going.
He hit four and then he wins it. And he like it was such an emotional. Like, Bateman told me Bateman's watched that moment. He said like 10 or 15 times because it's such like an actual sports moment.
Mike starts crying.
But like emotionally, No. Dude. But not in a way you're like, oh my god, this is trivia. It's like, dude, you can feel it. How many meant to him?
It was crazy.
And he's like hugging Ken and like it was such an emotional moment.
Yeah, fell into Ken.
Yeah, man.
Like, collapsed.
All corruption came together and like we're hugging. It was
who's corruption again? Chance, Grace. Ken, Grace.
Chance, Ken, Grace, Stacey, Howard, yeah. Tim Franco wasn't there, but it was a great moment in the interview. So anyway, that's the main event.
Yeah, and honestly though, I told Smets this afterwards. You're not supposed to be on a stage in Comic-Con as a rookie you are. It's okay.
Yeah, he quoted Riley, right? I said you got to learn how to lose before you can win.
Right. Yep. Yeah, and I heard him say that. But you're just Mike is, and not dropping kayfabe for a second, Mike deserves this. Mike needs to be exactly where he's going.
Yeah, and it's
dangerous right now.
He is, fucking but dangerous. You could see it in his face because,
he wants it.
He wants it so bad, and he's a performer and a star and a piece of poop and a dickhead. But, but he deserves to be there.
So this is why we tell you guys, and it's funny because the second he won, we started seeing more people wanting to get tickets to the Schmodown. And we're backing it up now. The
Wildberries versus.
That's going to probably be in Arizona.
Oh, got it.
But
Mike Kalinowski versus me.
Yeah, Mike Kalinowski versus Rachel Cushing. Get your tickets now. The SchmodownLive.com. You can get those tickets. The other thing that we could talk about real quick.
Well, who's the undercard?
Undercard I'm working on right now. I just have to see once Marvel, because I have someone in mind. It's just that they might have to do coverage for the Marvel thing right afterwards. So I just have to see if I can get them there in time to do it. So
what about the other person?
Confirmed.
But you can't tell us?
Because if the other person doesn't... Well, I can tell you right now, Kevin Smets is going to be on undercard. But if...
Wow, what?
Kevin Smets will be on undercard, another Intergeekdom match, but just a matter of who he's playing. If the person drops out, then I have to get another undercard and Kevin won't be on it. That's why I was going to say that.
Interesting. What a twist.
Yeah.
And Riley says you got to learn to lose before you can learn to win. You can also be in my camp and you got to learn to lose to keep losing.
Yeah, he wants to get back on the horse right away.
Art.
You think it's a mistake to get back on the horse that quick?
I don't think it's a mistake to get back on the horse, but on that stage I do.
Maybe.
It's not why he's supposed to be there, and he's not supposed to be there.
All right, interesting. But the other thing, we'll talk about it maybe tomorrow, but there's also, we got to talk about the Odd Couple and Shire Wolves match. We'll talk about that tomorrow, because the whole event is up on the Schmodown channel, so go check it out. It's the Movie Trivia Schmodown.
I love my boys. I love them so much.
We fucking heard it, Roxy.
No,
God,
I love my boys so much.
But it was a great match. They deserve it. But all four of them. That team match made them great. All right. So moving on, everybody.
By the by.
Yes.
Din.
Moving on. Driving in today. The It 2 signs are up all over Warner Brothers.
Yeah, they are. Can't wait to take it.
So I was up at Kind of Funny this weekend, and they have a Josh McCouga up there, but they don't.
Worse?
He's not as bad as me. No, but they were saying what would it take for us to sit you two in a theater alone together and watch It Chapter 2? Like, we'll see if we can like rent out it, because they have a deal with Alamo Draft House or something. And I was like, well, if the whole Collider crew, if like you guys are all outside the theater, or if like we have a party afterwards and they set up a GoPro or something. We were talking about this weekend, because I was like, well, listen, I have to go to a screening with these guys, and I was like, I don't know if I'm ever going to want to watch it again. And he was like, what did you think of the first chapter? And I was like, well, I was scared to death. And I was like, half the people like, so you remember that part in It? And I was like, no, I had my hands covered my eyes half the time.
But would it make it better to see it a second time, because you would know where the jumps are?
No, it wouldn't. I would know when they were coming and like be
worse.
I mean, just
it doesn't change the tone of the film.
Does not at all. And then we started talking about, you know, like things that he was scared of, whatever. And then they brought up the video of me screaming when the It person came in.
The Us person.
And they were just like, they all thought that it was fake. And even Scarpino was like, he was like, I know you really well, and I don't think you could act that well. And I was like, no, I can't. I was legitimately terrified.
Yeah. I have never received nicer things said about me on this show than that day. Everybody's like, wow, it's so nice to see you really had his back when these other two threw him right under the bus. You protected him. You saved him.
You were in a chair.
I was like,
She was in a chair and she didn't know the bit was happening.
Yes.
give me all the credit.
And the plan continued to come to fruition.
Behind the scenes, totally. She was pissed off that we didn't tell her that she was going to be
on
the bed.
No, I'm the savior.
You are.
I'm
the doula.
Say it out loud,
doula.
Josh. I'm the savior.
You are.
The doula.
Savior.
The plan. She's your doula.
You're a great hobbit, elf, and savior.
Doula.
Doula.
And a doula. And doula.
Yeah. She's the doula.
What is
She's
a doula, doula avangada? What is that?
Doula avangada. The water boy.
Water boy.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
All right. Listen. So let's move on before we have to go to break. We have 10 minutes of some.
What are we going to talk about?
Well, I was thinking.
Real quick. Stay tuned for the 11:30 hour. We have three copies of a remastered Forrest Gump 25th anniversary. It's a two-disc Blu-ray. We're doing calls and questions.
Questions about the show.
About the show.
So only call in if you think you call out a live history.
Yeah, and you can get a Forrest Gump copy. Three of them.
Okay, good.
We got for three different people.
We'll do that. All right, so then let's...
And maybe a couple of little funny Forrest Gump trivia questions.
Yeah.
Well, we should do that.
There's a lot of news then, so what we should do is...
A ton of news.
Let's hit one big story. This was something that I had heard, and then I asked you to check it this morning about the James Gunn Guardians of...
Guardians of the Galaxy. So James Gunn on Instagram, he got just a ton of DMs saying, please don't make Guardians Volume 3 as Guardians of the Galaxy because of what happens with Endgame.
Please don't make it the title, or please don't make that the concept?
They just kept saying the title. Like, don't make as Guardians of the Galaxy. You could look at it as both. Don't make it the title. Don't focus just on Thor and the Guardians. We want a full Volume 3. He screenshot the DMs and then he'd put up on Instagram, don't worry. That's about it. That's his comment.
Does anybody else low-key love As Guardians of the Galaxy?
Yes.
Yeah.
As a person of puns?
Love it.
I love that.
A lot of
I
people
like the concept.
Do. That's why I was confused. At all
I'm confused
stuff.
Too.
He's got a lot of the please don't let people. I've heard like the opposite. I've heard people who really want this.
Yeah.
But here's the other thing. People are now taking this as him saying, definitely not going to happen. Not once does he say that.
No, he just says don't worry.
So
I got this.
It's like, trust me, I got it covered.
Well, he's going to do his Volume 3. I mean, look at the mess that happened before he came back to this. He's making Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3.
He has a script for it, too.
He has a script for it.
But it's almost too clever to not call it that.
I wouldn't rule out Thor 4 being as Guardians of the Galaxy.
But it's not going to be this.
But not his.
No, I don't
think
it's going to make
as much sense. You think there's going to be a Thor 4?
I think so. Yeah, I think they're gonna try to get Taika Waititi back.
I think there's gonna be a Thor 4. I think that Thor is now with the Guardians.
Yeah, Hemsworth has been saying he wants to go back, and I think that if Taika Waititi comes back, Taika Waititi though is gonna be busy. He's
really
doing Akira.
Busy.
He's doing all these movies. So I don't know,
Flash
but
Gordon.
I would if I were Marvel. You reinvigorated with Ragnarok, and you had all that fun with Endgame and Infinity War with some of the Guardians. Why not?
Is there some sort of storyline in the comic books that is as Guardians of the Galaxy that like fans don't like, or is it because
there is a comic?
Because first of all, my favorite porn ever is As Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yeah, I guess so. First appearance as Guardians of the Galaxy was September 2018. It actually was. It was in the comic books. Yeah.
So cool.
So recent.
That's around Infinity War.
Yeah.
So I think
I think it's great.
Yeah.
I love that idea.
But also, why does anybody think that they should be able to tell the creator what to do? That's already done.
What?
Twitter.
That doesn't make sense. Like, please don't do this. Please.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, no, the irony is as how many times I ask you guys, please, please, please on anything. But it doesn't make sense. Let him do his thing.
Well, I mean, I think he's going to.
You guys fought for him to come back so hard.
That's probably why he said don't worry also, because remember, before he left, he already had the script done.
Yeah.
And I don't think it was as Guardians of the Galaxy. I just think it would be – I just liked – from what I saw at the end there with that dynamic with Thor and all of them, that's the movie I wanted to see. But I'm in the minority because I don't like the second movie. Most people love the second movie.
I liked it.
The Guardians. Yeah, a lot of people
do. I love it.
Most people do. Yeah. I'm in the minority.
I'm with you. Yeah.
We're in the minority.
Yeah.
And so I would like to see it, but there is a big majority that just wants to see the continuation of what he's done so far in the first. And it worked big. They made a lot of money, so why not go and do exactly the same thing that you did in the first two? Because he's got, and again, regardless of what I think about the second movie, even though I think the humor worked very well, he knows what he's doing because it's working with his audience. So he should continue to do whatever the fuck he wants to do.
Whatever he wants.
Yeah. So either way, whether it is or isn't, fans should just say, okay, James Gunn is back. You wanted him back, and let him do his thing.
Yeah. So even if it's the same plot as Guardians of the Galaxy, but they don't call it as Guardians of the Galaxy, the fans will be happy? Is that what the F this is?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Do they just not like puns? What's wrong with people?
I don't know. I mean, it depends on who's writing. It could be the same person with 57 accounts. You know, it's like, or maybe it, maybe true. It isn't. Or it could be a different group that just doesn't want that particular thing to happen. Or maybe there's just, I mean, there's also could be pocket of people who just love Guardians and don't like the MCU. You know, mm-hmm. So. Who knows?
Do you think there's people out there that don't like the MCU but just like Guardians?
Yeah, could be. Why not?
I think there's people out there fill in that blank. Anything.
Yeah. Yeah. Probably. Right.
People yes. out there who.
Yes, the perfect example. Like last night, my mother-in-law said, "I'm going to see the new Spider-Man. I love Spider-Man." I go, "What'd you think of Avengers: The Last Avengers?" Wouldn't see that. Yeah. Like you, I said, "You're gonna have no idea what's happening in this movie." Yeah. She's like, "No, it's Spider-Man." I was like, "But this movie does." You have to see Avengers.
She's like,
"I'll just watch Infinity War then." I go, "No, you gotta watch both." Mm-hmm. I don't know if I'll watch the first one. I'm like, "Oh my God." I was like, "Right, listen, just go and watch it." And I was like, "You know what? I'll answer all," because she's going to have 70,000 questions when she gets back.
I don't think I even asked you guys, Spider-Man. Yeah. You liked it?
Yeah, a lot.
Loved it.
Yeah.
Loved it.
You?
Would you?
Yeah, I did. Not as much as Homecoming, though.
Yeah, I'm with you on that.
I think it was a great MCU movie.
Yeah.
No, seriously, I think it was more.
I'm just giggling because that's how you always phrase. Like,
but it's true. I think it was more. It was more of an MCU movie, obviously, than Homecoming was. I mean,
yeah.
Homecoming had. I mean, it had.
I don't understand why this is the end of Phase 3, though. It should have been Endgame to me. It's confusing.
It was kind of like when Ant-Man was.
I know. It's the same thing. I didn't think that made much sense.
That one didn't make sense. I understand this one.
Well, I do too.
This one really connects to Endgame.
And I can't spoil, unfortunately, but it really does, I think, tie up everything that was set up from the first one like really well to where it kind of puts a bow on it.
Yeah, for all that stuff. But I think it's half and half what you're saying. Great MCU movie, Spider-Man movie, whew.
Yeah.
Because of, again, we can't spoil. But,
oh, right, because the movie's not out yet, right?
No, it comes out Wednesday. This weekend, too.
Tomorrow.
Third?
Tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll do a
spoiler. Today's the first.
So maybe the third?
Yeah.
Maybe on Wednesday?
I think so. When we get back, I think it is Wednesday night.
Yeah, Wednesday,
When we get back from the holiday break, because I was going to say break now, because we're going to break. But when we get back from the holiday break, we'll do a full-on spoiler review.
Okay, maybe next Monday.
I don't know about Monday. Maybe Monday or Tuesday.
What is the schedule of the show?
So I know that we have. I don't. What's the deal? I don't know. Friday. What is Friday? No one knows yet. So it looks like Thursday. We're definitely off. I'm not here on Friday. You're not here on Friday. Are you here on Friday? Well, you're not here on Friday either.
I'm not usually, but I could be.
Yeah, well, okay. So nobody
I'm
knows.
Not here. Right.
We're all yeah. We're show. All right.
Yeah.
So, Cody, are you here on Friday?
I think so. I don't know what's going
on. So chances are that there's not going to be a show on Thursday and Friday. We don't know yet. But definitely not one on Thursday.
Living on the edge.
And there really might be a Cody and Alex show on Friday. So
but why can't I come?
They're the producers of the show. Talk to them on Friday.
Okay.
Yeah. But that's the schedule of the show. And then it's Comic-Con week, which is in front of the 2 or 3 weeks. Wednesday I leave that morning. So but we'll still be doing shows.
I'll be here.
I'll be here throughout the week. So if you want me to host Thursday.
As of now I am too. So
we'll have a full week of shows either way. So I just wanted to make sure everybody kind of knew that was the overall schedule of it. If you didn't know already that this show lives on both its own YouTube channel, Clire Live, as well as podcast feeds. You can get them on Stitcher or Spotify. Make sure you do that. Subscribe to it. Always leave comments and
remember
share.
When we found out we had a Twitter?
Like last week, I think we found that out. Yeah, Collider Live apparently has a Twitter feed too, so make sure you check that out.
150,000 subs, we'll do a live show.
Yeah,
we've gained 10,000 or something since we announced. But we're at like 85 or something.
Well, we said 82. By Comic Con. Let's say if we get 150,000 by Christmas, we'll do a live holiday show.
#100 make a hashtag.
Okay.
The closest we're gonna get is the thing screening. That's the closest we're going to get.
That'd be fun, though.
Because the Arclight wants to do it. I don't know if anybody's reached out yet.
I've talked to Jack. Yeah.
Okay. So Jack knows about it.
You better listen, Jack.
Yeah.
Well done, Roxy.
Hopefully he does listen. And we're able to do that because if they set it up, then we can do that. We'll do a little Clatter Live beforehand. Then it'll lead into the actual screening. So there you go.
Right on.
Fuck it. Let's go to break now. When we get back, we'll do we'll do some more news, and then we'll talk obviously about this Masters of the Universe thing, what the hell's happening with it. And then remember, 11:30, we're taking phone calls from you guys to do this giveaway. So only call in if you think you know the show well enough. Saul, I'm sure you're gonna call in.
Hey guys, Riley here, and let me tell you about Rule of Two. You looking for a Star Wars fix? Well, Rule of Two is that show. It drops on Collider Video's main YouTube channel, as well as on Podcast One's Jedi Council feed. So go over there, subscribe, share it with your friends. It's hosted by myself and Mark Fernandez. We talk everything in the Star Wars universe with a lot of deep dives and a lot of conversations that go all in. You know what to do. Subscribe, join us there, and rise.
Hey everyone, John Rocha here, the host of Collider Mailbag. New episode drops every Saturday and Sunday in your face and in your ears, answering the questions from you fans about the world of entertainment, film, and
Wouldn't
television.
You like to know
Me
weather,
and
boy.
Great guests from our sphere do the best to answer your questions from Twitter, from Instagram, and of course, email as well, every Saturday and Sunday.
And I'm gonna beat that ass.
Hi, I'm Koi Jandro, host of Collider Heroes, and I'm here to tell you we've got 20-minute episodes coming at you on Collider Video, on the YouTube, as you've always loved it. Plus, now we've got hour-long podcasts dropping every Thursday, so make sure to subscribe to the podcast because it's going to get even more sweaty on the podcast. Plus, every week we're going to try to get some very special guest interviews, all of the people that help shape these movies and TV shows you love. So, video, podcast, interviews all coming at you. Be sure to subscribe. Thanks so much, guys. Stay sweaty.
Hey guys, Perry Nemiroff here to let you know that The Witching Hour is all over Collider right now. You can listen to that horror-filled podcast with myself, with Haley Fouch. We talk about witchiness. We talk about slashers. We talk about space horror. You name it, all on that show on the Collider Factory feed. We also have clips on the Collider Podcast YouTube channel. And on top of that, you can find an article all about Witching Hour every single Tuesday on Collider.com. Check it out. Get scared. Hopefully you survive the witching hour.
What's up, Collider fans? Ryan Satin here from ProWrestlingSheet.com, where you can find the top stories throughout the week in the world of professional wrestling. If you're a wrestling fan like myself, then you'd be doing yourself a disservice by not checking out all the shows we do every week on YouTube.com/C/WrestlingSheet. In particular, on Wednesdays, we've got a SmackDown recap show hosted by John Rocha and myself, where we pick apart and talk about every little thing that happened on the Blue Brand. So do yourself a favor and go subscribe at youtube.com/C/WrestlingSheet.
Hey guys, Perry here to let you know about the new edition of Collider Movie Talk. We are going to 5 days a week. We have a short, sweet, 20-minute show where we focus on the two biggest stories of the day. You can expect to see all of your favorite Collider personalities on the show, including Jeff Snyder, John Rocha, Haley Fouch. You're getting Josh McCuga every Friday. We're going to have a blast. It's going to be informative, fun. Come join us. 3 p.m. PT live every single day of the week right here on the Collider Video YouTube channel. You can also find the show on the Collider Movie Talk feed on our podcast network, so go watch, go listen, however you prefer to get all of your movie news.
Hey everyone, John Rocha here, the host of Collider Sports Time. Well, you know, if you've been watching us every week, you know we break down the latest and the greatest in the world of sports, talk about the big issues, the big games, all of it with a rotating band of guests like Matt Nose and Josh McCuga. We've had Taylor Bisciotti on. We've had so many great guests. Now, if you want to see more of Sports Time or you want to try it out for the first time, remember to subscribe to Collider Sports YouTube channel. And if you want to take us along with you in your ears, you can go and subscribe to the Collider Sports podcast feed for all the sports goodness.
Hey guys, it's Riley here. Let me tell you about the Riley Roundtable. You know it, right? It drops every Thursday on Collider Conversations, and I have guests from all across the space. John Rocha, Gray Drake, Alexander Desplat came on at one point. We talk everything from movies, we talk about life, and everything in between. Jesus. What do you want to hear? What do you want to talk about? It's the Riley Roundtable every Thursday on Collider Conversations.
You get it there.
Hello. How are you guys doing? I'm Christian Harloff. I'm the host of Collider Jedi Council. We talk about everything Star Wars. And if you want to catch our weekly show where we talk about the latest and greatest in Star Wars, it's movie news, it's canon, it's all of it. We take questions from you guys. How do you do it? Main channel. That's right. Right here. Subscribe to this channel and you can listen. You can watch. You can do all of it. But if you want to just listen to it, you got the podcast feed too. Stitcher, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, whatever it is, you can listen to it in your car. Do all of it. It's Star Wars. Episode 9 is coming out. And then after Episode 9, you got TV shows. So we're going to be your sports center for Star Wars. Do it. Come on. Be real.
I think that's the Space Jam song, isn't it?
You're damn right it is, Josh. NBA free agency. What's your hot take?
Oh! Everybody's going to Brooklyn for some reason, but don't worry. Kevin Durant's not going to play for a year, and the Nets are still going to stink. Hey, Brooklyn, the Nets, where talent goes to die. All right, let's hear it for the NBA. More importantly, how about that cast of Space Jam, Cody? Cody, LeBron James, a bunch of people I've sort of heard of, and a couple WNBA stars.
You got Anthony Davis in there.
Anthony Davis?
Probably, like the center. I can't imagine the look of these monsters.
I mean, here's the thing. Anthony Davis sort of looks like a monstar with that unibrow.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Good call. Good call.
Yeah, some monstars. Cody, I know that you're psyched about Space Jam. Do you know one thing that you don't know about me? Maybe you do. Uh-huh. I've never seen Space Jam all the way through.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Really?
Nope. You know, it was in that
Turn
point.
Turn off your mic now.
He turned it off.
He legit turned
it off. Well, I'll pick it up there because I've seen Space Jam. I've seen it at least twice.
Oh, man. No, see, it was in that part of my life. When did it come out? Like 96?
1995.
Like okay, so I was like 13. I was like
was
way
it 95?
Too.
95? I don't know.
I was like way too cool for school. I was like, I'm not going to watch Michael Jordan play cartoons. Like, what, bro? I'm not doing that. And now later in life, I'm like, maybe I should go watch Space Jam because all the people I work with love it so damn much.
Cinematic treasure.
Two words. 1996.
See, I was 14 years old.
Off.
Just getting into high school. So I'm not watching cartoons. Play basketball, bro.
Two words for you about Space Jam.
What?
Bill and Murray.
Yeah, this I know. Yeah.
Cody, Bill Murray.
Is he the best part of Space Jam, Bill Murray?
He's pretty freaking good.
Are you kidding?
Interesting.
He is the best part.
Where are the other two people?
I don't know.
No idea.
I think they're in the back.
It's Collider Live. We're back. It's Monday. It's the 1st of July.
It is the 1st of July.
And we got a lot of news. And coming up at the 11:30 hour, of course, courtesy of Paramount, we have three copies of the new Blu-ray remastered Forrest Gump. It's the 25th anniversary. We're doing some Forrest Gump questions, but... We're also doing some Collider Live questions.
Collider Live, inside Collider Live. So if you watch the show, you should be able to get these questions correct. I'm gonna write a couple deep.
I need some deep cuts. I just threw them together, and we are going to talk about some news once we actually have people on the show.
You know what's weird is that I think that we should have like a sign on the bathroom stalls that's like, listen, at 11 o'clock, nobody can be in the bathrooms.
Yeah, because that bathroom
unless
was,
you're on Collider
we
Live.
Used the bathroom because there was one available and somebody's in the bathroom.
Yes.
And they've been there, probably still there.
There's only two bathrooms in the Collider Studios.
Is.
And I believe that bathroom is currently being occupado and that should not be allowed. So between like 10:55 and 11:05, you can't be in the bathrooms. I know that's like probably against fire laws and laws in general, but Cody, what do you think of that? Do you think that's like an okay rule?
I think that makes sense.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Right?
To stop people like...
And I'm going to beat that ass.
Yeah.
In there and just pooping all the time.
Correct.
And you know, it wasn't him this time.
No.
Well, hey, everybody. Welcome back to the show. It's Collider Live.
Thank you.
Roxy Stryer coming in.
Here we go.
Christian Harloff, your host, is back.
Yeah, well, you know, people.
I know.
Other people.
We were discussing
piss breaks.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's what we said. We think that the toilet should not be occupied between 10:55 and 11:05 by other people that aren't on Collider Live.
Yes, I agree.
How do we implement that rule?
Put a sign.
I don't know.
Just put a sign on the door.
Bathroom out of use.
Yeah,
Cody, close the bathroom.
Yeah, Cody, close the bathroom.
Put some like cones in front.
Correct.
You know what? We should get some of those like automatic locks, Cody, that you could control from the back there.
Oh.
Cody, sure. Yeah, exactly. You hear him laugh because Cody would be doing it right now to people.
Totally.
That's the kind of person Cody is.
Did we ever find the pooper?
No.
Never found the pooper.
It's officially a cold case.
Yeah. No. I mean, I think I have my
ideas. Interesting.
I have my ideas.
I still have the piece of paper that you wrote on that you put an arrow to somebody standing. So yeah. I think that's the pooper.
Well, right now you're the pooper. So
I'm the pooper.
Let's get some of this shit out of the way. What do we got?
Okay. Well, we have our first trailer for Jumanji, The Next Level.
Yes.
It's the new cast that we get some Danny DeVito. We get some Danny Glover. We get a little twist on the concept.
Yeah. And I like the trailer.
What happened?
It's pretty damn good.
No, I was just thinking about, what's so crazy with my mind when with movies, not with TV, and this is why I don't compete in the Schmodown. Mm. I love the Jumanji movie that came out a couple years ago, whenever it was. I love the movie. I've probably seen it three times. I didn't even remember a main character.
Oh,
like,
yeah, right.
I just can't believe that. And like as you're saying that, I'm like, oh my god, yeah, I forgot. Yeah. I just watched that trailer. There's something about movies that don't retain in my brain the way that TV shows do.
Yeah, well, the movie made almost $962 million.
It deserved it.
The second
so
one. This is the third Jumanji.
Yeah, I keep calling it the first, but the second. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yeah, it's
a soft reboot, but all connected.
No, it was a sequel, man.
Yeah,
it's good.
But they wanted to like they had that
franchise.
Conversation.
Yes, yeah. So anyway, this is the and it would make sense that they did a sequel 2 years later to the 2017 version, and they put a little spin on this one.
Yeah,
they put a little spin on it because they showed Danny DeVito. I was wondering why they were showing Danny DeVito and Glover, right? It's like, why is I was gonna say Donald, but Danny Glover, and you're like, why are they showing them if they're just in it for like the beginning and these kids are going back into it? And it turns out that this time around, it's not Nat Wolff that's taken over The Rock. It's Danny DeVito, and this time Donald Glover's taken over Kevin Hart.
Danny.
I said Donald Glover.
Yeah, you did.
It's hard.
Thank you.
I know.
Well, Donald Glover. Which is crazy. Yeah. I was such a big Lethal Weapon fan. Never in a million years would I get to...
What I watched last night. The Lethal Weapon was just on.
The first one.
Danny is... my grandfather's name is Donald. We call him Danny. So that's why it's even...
You do it all the time. Danny Glover. And then the only thing that I'm going to give him like the benefit of the doubt. I don't know how long I'm going to be able to take The Rock doing Danny DeVito's voice.
That's what I was saying. Even in the trailer, it was tough. And I'm not even saying he's doing a bad job that, but that voice not on Danny DeVito is so jarring. The Rock, we just know him inside and out. He's a superstar, but he's not a character actor.
But he's also a guy that works hard. He never half-asses anything that
Definitely.
He does. And he's going to put a lot of effort into it for sure. And that's why I'm not going to just take the trailer. Because if you look at it, you could say, okay, this might get old. But because of what The Rock has done in his career, I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt that I think it's going to turn out to be pretty funny. And because Kevin Hart, who I thought was eventually – there's a lot of movies he was doing. A lot of them was that landed in like January that I was just getting tired of, right? I thought he annihilated me in the first – in the last Jumanji.
And he has a different voice in this trailer, and he nailed it.
Yeah, he did.
His different voice in this made perfect sense. There was something about The Rocks when he was
just didn't like it.
I agree with you. I can never question The Rock. I'm not going to doubt The Rock. You would have to be an idiot. He's so great. But what I saw in this trailer, it didn't quite land with me.
Okay. And that's fair and for both of us. So I just want to see what happens because same director, yes?
I don't know, actually.
Yes.
Let me look.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, Awkwafina's in it? Did we see her in the trailer?
No. Didn't see her in the trailer.
You did see Jonas.
Yeah,
she's my favorite. Yeah,
I love Awkwafina. Did anybody else see The Farewell yet?
No, that was it.
I've been asking you guys. Please.
I probably won't see it in the theater.
Please.
I'll
probably wait until
it comes. We watched Always Be My Maybe, finally.
Hey, Alex.
That is fantastic.
So wait, hey, Alex is so
Alex
good.
I saw The Farewell.
How good is it, Alex?
It's amazing. It's my number one so far.
It is unreal. It's the movie is...
Oh,
it's so
what you were telling me about
last
week. Okay,
yes, it's so good. It's so good. You know when the PR emails you afterwards and says, what did you think?
Yeah.
And you have to, like, run, hide. You don't know what to say back. I was so excited.
There
I was
three
like,
paragraphs.
Oh, my God. Yeah. It was amazing. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yeah, so nice.
That's
awesome. So good.
Yeah, well, Nick Jonas was actually pretty good in the last one, too.
I did like him in that.
He was good. Yeah. So
I can't tell them apart.
No,
the Jonas kids.
No,
what?
So wait,
brothers.
Nick Jonas is the one who married Sophie Turner over the weekend, right?
No,
right.
No.
Oh,
no, that's Joe Jonas.
Joe Christian.
Joe is the one who's missing.
Yeah. No. Nick is in this one.
Nick is in this.
Joe
one.
Is, give me Joe married that I Sophie didn't know Turner, that. And then there's also a third Jonas.
Kevin Jonas, right?
I don't know.
Kevin? Stanley.
They
Jonas?
All very look. Yes, Snarky Joe, Snarkos Jonas.
Yeah. Jonas. What's the third one?
Kevin.
Nick, Joe, Kevin, Jack, Lawless, John Lloyd. Oh, this is, it doesn't matter. We went down to
Nick Jonas, Joe Jonas, Kevin. Yeah. Wait, Joe Jonas married Sophie Turner? Who's Nick Jonas
Lawless.
Married to?
Do you guys know before Ben was Ben Bateman, he wanted to be Benjamin Lawless? That was going to be his name.
Really?
His real name's not Bateman?
Do people not know that?
No.
Well, they do
I'm
know.
Glad he's not Lawless.
Okay. So, anyway,
Priyanka Chopra, what?
I'm very curious.
Married to Nick Jonas?
Oh, yeah. I knew that.
Very curious to see what the audience thought of the Jumanji trailer. Did you think it looks fun? Yeah. Did you like the last one? If so, does it look like it's going to match up? Did you like The Rock doing this voice? Do you think that it's going to work throughout the entire film? Go ahead and comment, whether you're in the live chat or watching this on the replay, please, or on the clip out. Either way, let us know. All right, next.
We got a big one, and this comes from Variety, and it's Melissa McCarthy is in talks to play Ursula.
It's really good casting.
The live-action Little Mermaid. Like
I'm on the Lizzo train.
What's that mean?
Oh, have you guys not been seeing this?
What's the Lizzo train?
Oh, just Lizzo's perfect.
Who's Lizzo? Who's Lizzo?
What?
Who's Lizzo?
What?
Elizabeth Banks?
First of all, you're not allowed to say what when half the things we say, you say, wait, what?
So, Lizzo is one of the biggest pop stars right now in the world.
We don't know what it
is. This is the first Lizzo I've seen.
So confused right now.
Oh, okay.
They don't know either. You don't know who Lizzo is either, right?
But it's been all over Twitter. Like, people are pushing for Lizzo to be Ursula.
I don't go to Twitter unless I'm tweeting out Schmodown.
Okay.
Is she the girl that, like... She's...
Whatever.
Anyway,
so
Melissa McCarthy's fine, but yeah. I thought Queen Latifah was a good pick when they were talking about Queen Latifah, and then I was on the Lizzo train.
Okay.
I think that Melissa McCarthy would be fine. I like her a lot.
You think she'll overcome it?
I don't know.
I don't know who Lizzo is, but second of all, has Lizzo ever acted in anything?
Music videos.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Okay, so
I mean, Melissa McCarthy is Ursula. If you've ever watched the show Nobodies, she is Ursula for 100%.
She's great. She's excellent.
I think she can sing she's a great singer, too.
Is that true?
Yeah.
That's what I question. How do we know that?
I don't know that for a fact, but I'm pretty sure she's a very talented singer. But I might be wrong. But yeah. And what is Lizzo a singer or is she a rapper?
Yes.
She is a singer.
Okay.
Well, and she does a little bit of both, but she's very.
Melissa McCarthy is in talks.
It's not a done deal yet.
So it'd be very interesting if she gets it. There's no word on who Ariel is or anything, too.
They've been talking about Zendaya.
Oh, have they?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, play Ariel?
Mm-hmm.
So,
that's good.
Yeah.
That's not confirmed, but that was the rumor.
Okay. And then when that's supposed
to
come out?
Can she sing?
Did they have a release date yet? If you can pull up that thing, I can't get the computer yet. No, it's fine.
She was in the Hugh Jackman.
Oh, Greatest
Showman.
All right, we don't need Greatest Showman. But where's not you. They were bringing it up Greatest Showman. We don't need that. but I just want to know when this fucking movie's coming out.
I wonder if it's been dated yet. I haven't
heard
much.
Little Mermaid? I think it.
2022 or something? 2023? All right, what's the next story?
I think 2022. I think that's accurate.
What's the next story?
The next
Nobody
story.
Has information on these stories.
I know.
But before we move to the next,
I don't think it's been dated.
Before we move to the next story, are you guys excited about a live-action Little Mermaid or no?
It was never really one of my favorite animated films. I'm always excited for these movies when they come out because I get to take my daughter to them.
But I mean, because of the underwater aspect of it all,
could
and
be
it
fun.
Being, okay,
could be fun. But I'm looking forward to The Lion King.
This one is one of the ones I'm looking forward to. Yeah.
I like the first one. I like about the crab. He's the best.
Sebastian.
He's the best.
I like the crab. He's the best.
You know who's going to voice him? Stanley Tucci.
Tucci is doing a crab.
Is that the one you want?
That's it.
I got something for you.
Oh.
I know you didn't know it, but guess what? The mermaid movie.
Yeah.
It's coming out.
Uh-huh.
And the crab. It's the fucking Tucci.
Oh, hey. He got his choppers out. He's clipping.
Like
he's clacking.
It's the roll.
Oh,
it's the move.
He got a little this, a little that. He got a little clicky clacky. He's
doing
a Tooch. I got
a friend named the Gooch and the Crab, voiced by that Tooch.
You know, he's under the sea. He's clipping and he's clacking.
Cut your fucking nails.
What if Tucci is the Crab?
I would be very happy.
Yes,
for that.
Me too.
You know what?
Mm-mm.
You wouldn't be happy with that?
I don't think it'd be good casting.
Wait,
why? Who do you want?
Do your Tucci. I just saw it.
It was coming out, but it's gone now.
But it's the one little thing. I say do it.
It's gone now. It's got to be. There's a rhythm to it.
Once it's gone, it's gone.
It's like.
No, you did it. You went like, you know, Ariel.
Yeah, I know, but it's gone now.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, it's gone.
He knows he did it, and now he knows
it's gone.
It's
over. Now it's over.
My bad.
Keep up.
Do we have anything else?
We do. Yeah. This is my favorite news of the weekend. According to THR, we are getting a Sandman series over at Netflix.
with Neil Gaiman coming on board and David Goyer, your boy. David Goyer is going to showrun this thing. And we got screenwriter Alan Heinberg is set to pen the series and also be a showrunner. So this is good.
Why do you say David Goyer, your boy?
Because you were interviewing him the other day.
We'll
bring it,
they're best friends.
Bring it up during,
they're best friends.
We'll actually bring it up during the Masters conversation, too. But it was just an interview for Vader Immortal.
Yeah.
I got a chance to talk to him.
Was he great?
He was very open about everything.
Was he great?
He was nice. I mean, I can't. There's no assessment of.
Do you think he was great?
A great person. Him and Stooch.
Yeah,
Stooch.
The Stooch's brother, the Stooch.
The Stooch.
Wait. What the fuck is Sandman? Why are you so excited about this?
It's a graphic novel series, comics by Neil Gaiman.
No.
Yep.
I've already been screwed by American Gods. Good Omens is the worst.
I'm hearing from everybody. Good Omens rocks.
It's the worst.
Oh. Damn. Really?
I've watched two episodes. It's the worst.
I got the Doom Patrol DVDs coming to me.
What do you think?
I'll tell you in the future.
Doom Patrol's so good.
Did you hear what I said to start that?
I said they're coming. Yeah.
I just
wanted you to be clairvoyant.
I'm so out of these Neil Gaiman properties. It's just boring.
Listen, The Sandman is one of those series.
Joseph Gordon-Levitt involved in this?
Joseph Gordon-Levitt is not mentioned in this article. He was developing this for many, many years. Somebody asked me on Twitter, would I want him to be involved? Sure. But I think because he was looking to direct it
Has he lost his buzz?
I don't know.
Gordon-Levitt?
Haven't heard.
We
from
just
him,
watched 50-50 over the weekend.
Yeah, I know, but that was 2011.
And that is fantastic, and he's so good in that. He shouldn't be losing his buzz.
He's a phenomenal actor. I'm not saying as far as his talent. I'm saying there was a time where he was like hot.
He hasn't been
shit lately.
Yeah.
When he was attached, this was going to be the whole dark universe that DC was doing. Mm. Correct. That was the whole.
Oh, that might have been.
They were doing a whole shebang.
Well, this is the Vertigo imprint. This is a fantastic series. It's about Morpheus. He's the Sandman. He controls the dreams, and this is
Well, but this is interesting too because you're saying it's going to be a series that is coming to Netflix, which is extremely confusing considering their other Vertigo properties are not there, and even Swamp Thing getting canceled, being over on the DC app. Why would this be going to Netflix?
Well, Netflix paid a massive price tag for the series.
That's why.
This is what they're saying: is that this was a big hot property. Where it was going to go? It was the most expensive TV deal that Warner Brothers has ever conducted.
You would think HBO, though. You would think that they would put it either there or on their Warner Media app or whatever. This doesn't make sense except for the paycheck, I guess. But I would not have done that if I was.
How long does it stay there though? If they're going to do, because it's Warner Brothers, right? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
So how long
it's
does
DC?
Yeah. How long does it stay there if they're going to do their own app?
I mean, clearly,
why
that's
would
what
you
they,
even sell
this
this
is what they seem to be doing, though. DC's properties are so spread out, it's massively confusing.
Yeah.
Well, it's like Marvel back in the day. Remember, before Marvel had the MCU and had Marvel Studios, they were selling off everything to everybody. That's why Fox got X-Men.
But we're not back in the day. They have their all, you know, and they have HBO.
Right.
They have
money.
They have all the places. Right. So what are you, why?
I know, I got a trivia question for you.
Hmm.
Okay. Joseph Gordon-Levitt was a voice in one of these movies. Which movie? Was it Justice League? Was it Guardians of the Galaxy? Or was it Star Wars The Last Jedi?
Star Wars The Last Jedi.
The Last Jedi.
The middle one.
Star Wars The Last Jedi. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Or it was a guess?
That was a total guess.
You see? You're a good guess.
I fell asleep in Canto Bite, of course.
What was the voice?
I don't know.
He's a stormtrooper.
I just saw it on his credits.
So here's the thing. All right,
I didn't know it.
Sell me, because I think, I've said it already. These Neil Gaiman properties have been a wash for me.
He was slow and low.
Yeah,
remember?
I was slow and low.
Yeah, he was slow and low. That was the best part of the whole movie. They're working on the standalone TV show. You know what it's about? You told me about it.
I did.
What is it about? Slow and low. He goes. He teams up with the Ewok.
Yeah, with the so it's slow and low.
Right.
The Ewok Donnie.
Donizio.
Does he have any siblings or family?
Yeah, Stanley Tucci is plays his father, obviously.
He just grunts a lot.
Yeah.
Danny DeVito as the uncle?
He plays the tall one. They're gay men, so they're lovers. Mm-hmm. And Neil Gaiman is not in it.
Oh,
he tried to write
men.
An episode. Gay men, yeah. Mm-hmm. Neil Gaiman tried to write an episode, but Tucci's like, get the fuck out. I'm tired of your gods and your good omens and bullshit.
And then that was over.
And that was it.
That's good.
Yeah. Six episodes on Amazon Prime. Oh. Check it out.
Slow and low.
Slow and low.
It doesn't make sense to go to Amazon Prime.
Exactly.
Go to your Disney streaming service.
Speaking of streaming services, there's a report out there.
But wait. What is Sandman? What is it about?
It's a comic series.
Yeah, about what? He controls dreams?
Character is one of the endless and omnipotent set of siblings that include destiny, death, destruction, despair, desire, and delirium. In keeping with the D motif, Morpheus is also known as Dream. That's right.
Can
he
I make a prediction?
Controls your dreams.
I want to make a prediction.
Okay. He's going to love it.
I think he's going to love it.
Yep.
I think he's going to love
it. It is fantastic.
You hated Inception, though, didn't you?
Did.
Maybe not.
It's not really Inception.
I love Inception.
It's a really dark, gothic kind of...
Doesn't sound anything like him.
Yeah.
Dorino will love
it. Right. Dorino.
Did you just choke on a penis?
Yeah.
On a what?
Did you see that?
on the mic.
Oh, boy.
The worst.
So too early in the morning?
The worst. Sorry.
So thank you, Cody.
Yeah. Thank you, Cody. Anyway,
hey, real quick. Nick Scarpino said he loves Collider Live. We're talking about it. He's like, I
love Nick Scarpino.
Yeah, he's the best.
He's one of my favorite people that I met through the Schmodown, by the way.
Yeah.
He really is. Awesome. Just
who's your favorite?
Out of everyone that I met at the Schmodown?
Makuga.
Well, I already knew you.
Oh, that's right.
I mean, as far as people who were brought into it, Scarpino's up there, man. He's just, you know why? Because he's just such
a... Okay, besides him.
Well, I'm talking about him.
Okay, but I'm asking besides him.
I don't know. He's a likable person. He's a likable human, and he's really is plucked from San Francisco, the Makuga of San Francisco. He's just one of those guys. He's always been kind of very open, doing some fun stuff for the Schmodown, being a big promoter of it. So I like those guys a lot.
Okay, and now you complimented him. Tell me something.
But when
else.
Greg came in here too, Greg from Kind of Funny, both those guys are just two guys that just get it. I wish they lived here because Greg was. He was the heel I've been looking for in the Schmodown.
Always.
He would rival Guy.
Guy's the best.
He would rival Guy. He's so good. So fucking good. Mm-hmm. Moving on. So if this is the thing that there's a report that came out, and again, I know that this is not from the Variety, it's not from Hollywood Reporter, and it's out there, and people are like, you can't take this story that serious, but it's still a rumor out there that I'm interested in, and was it We Got It Covered? Is that who said
Heroic Hollywood, right?
No, Heroic Hollywood.
No, We Got It Covered.
What are you talking about? Oh, you're talking about Darth Bane. Yeah. Yes.
Oh.
We got this covered.
So We Got This Covered. They had...
I don't buy it. Yeah. But yeah. I know. You like to talk
Hollywood
about
has broken some good stuff. But We Got This Covered is kind of comes out in... So We Got This Covered said that the Darth Bane series has been in development in Lucasfilm and that they're eyeing Batista to play Darth Bane.
Oh, that's, I like that.
And so, but people are running out and saying, this is bullshit. You can't take these guys serious. The only reason why, not the only reason, because I don't know these guys well enough to say whether they're not legit or not. I have also kind of heard buzzings about them wanting to explore other things that they have, and Darth Bane is something that I could definitely see them doing and potentially doing in a streaming series
with Batista.
Batista could play him. It's funny. If you asked me that 5 years ago, I'd be like, no. But I think he is dramatically improved as an actor.
And who do you think would be a better choice?
I've said this before. Kevin Durand. Not Durant. Durand. Kevin Durand, I think, is the best choice
Durant.
For Darth Bane. He is – because I've read the books, and I know exactly what kind of – they should definitely go off of the Drew Karpyshyn novels because there's so much content there that they could fill up 4 to 5 seasons of material. So I'm really hoping that they do it. I don't think Kevin Durand would get it because if this report is true that Lucasfilm like an A-lister to carry it because the property is – that's – I understand the logic. If, again, this is true, the logic would probably be – besides the hardcore Star Wars fan, not a lot of people know who Darth Bane is. He hasn't been involved in any of the movies. He's been mentioned in novels and comics and even in the Clone Wars. Mark Hamill voiced him in the Clone Wars. But that's the extent of it, right? As a hardcore Star Wars fan, you would know him. But as a casual, probably not. So their thinking would probably be, well, we want to take this material, but we need someone to sell who it is.
Can you pitch me a little bit about what it is?
Yeah. So
what the show would be?
Yeah. What I hope that it would be. Yeah. And what they say, this report says it could be, is Darth Bane he was very tall. He was like 6'5", living in this kind of a planet very similar to like Tatooine. It's about 1,000 years before Episode 4. It's during the Old Republic still. The Sith army and the Jedi army is still very much alive. There's thousands of Sith. There's thousands of Jedi, and they're fighting for the Jedi. As always, are trying to make sure that the Republic is in control, and the Sith are trying to take over power in general. As where Bane is, he's not Bane yet. I forget what his actual name is, but he's comes from a kind of an abusive home. His dad was bad to him, and he's kind of an angry dude.
What is his background?
Just kind of like a miner or something.
Yeah.
He's a mining planet, right? Yeah. And so he winds up getting into like this bar fight, and he gets recruited into the Sith army. And while he's there, he kind of because he realizes he's in tune with the Force, and he becomes but he uses anger. The Sith army trains him, and he becomes more and more powerful and powerful and powerful. By the end of the first novel, he realizes that the Sith are never going to overthrow the Jedi because there's always too many Sith inside that are trying to overthrow one another. So he realizes he's the one who creates the rule of two that you know from the Jedi. There's always one master, one apprentice. He creates that and he kills all of the Sith. Mm-hmm. Yeah, with like a
classic
like a
Sith move,
but he kills all
of the Sith,
all of them, and he does it through this powerful kind of Sith bomb towards a mental
Sith bomb.
Yeah, but it is this kind of, and he does this. But in this report, from what this report says, is that that it takes place after that, to where he's recruiting his apprentice and learning because they're kind of operating in the shadows.
I like this.
I would like to see it in the beginning of that. I think the thing that I just went through, I'd like to see that particular thing and how he becomes, because he does battle at times of like. Going in between, like
good and evil.
Yeah, but it's always leaning towards evil, because he's just
even though he kills all the Sith. Well
no, that's evil. That, he does that because he knows it's about power. He creates he finds like it's Darth Revan from Knights of the Republic. He finds like holocrons. He learns from Revan. He learns from all the he does all this under.
What's a holocron again?
It's like video files basically. It's where it's just they've been logged.
But that's
for
the
years.
End of the series. You
that's
think?
The end of book. No, that's the end of
but
book
I'm
one.
Wondering, is that what you're saying would be the end?
So no, the series.
You would
what
like to
saying,
see that as the end of the season.
I would like to see that as season one.
Okay,
that's what I would
but
like.
They're saying it picks up after that.
Yeah, from this report, if you believe
well,
this report,
I don't like that.
No, yeah. This report takes place after where he's already killed all the Sith, and now it's him operating in the shadows.
Talk about an origin story that we actually need, though.
Right.
Who the
maybe for budget but, if but they remember, were going to make a series.
Remember also that is not a canon novel. So nothing says that they have to say that that's how.
Totally, I just like what you just pitched.
Yeah, and that's Drew Karpyshian, man. That's not me. That's Drew Karpyshian. He also co-wrote Knights of the Republic with BioWare. Mm-hmm. He is a brilliant writer. That series, the Darth Bane trilogy, is some of the best written Star Wars stuff that has ever been put on paper.
Yeah.
And if they took all three of those books, they would have a hit series. I guarantee it. For 5 to 6 seasons, you could get material out of that thing. It'd be amazing.
Well, if that report is to be believed with Knights of the Old Republic movie, that they're adapting it from the game, maybe they could do the same here.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think the name Darth Bane is too close to like actual Bane in the DC universe that like the casual fan?
I was born in the darkness, raised by it.
Not only do I think that you can double up with the Bane name,
You
think Tom Hardy would be a great casting?
He's just too small. He's too small.
How tall is Batista?
Like 6'4", 6'5".
Really?
How tall is Batista? But he, even so, I go back to what I just said. Nothing says that Bane has to be that tall. He just is in the novels. He's 6'3".
Wow.
6'3". So, and can you do Kevin Durand? What's his height? Because Kevin Durand, he's 6'6". He would be perfect.
Yeah, he's
what is
good.
He from?
Not Kevin.
Kevin Durant's even taller.
Kevin, yeah. Kevin Durant was in.
Have you guys been paying attention to this?
No, I have. To the free agency. Yeah.
Yeah. The Knicks got screwed again. I texted my friends yesterday and I said, should we just become Nets fans?
Yeah.
I was like, at this point,
don't you wish that's how it worked?
I know. I was like, at this point, I don't think anybody would blame us.
But
you know why it is?
He's not going to play next year.
No, but you know why it is though that because they said nobody wants to play for the Knicks. It's for two reasons. It's just a disaster of a franchise, is one of the things right now. And it's also a toxic owner, man.
Totally.
Worst
owner in sports.
You got to get rid of him.
Mm-hmm.
Somehow. I don't know how
it's
you do
him
it.
Him and Mark Ellis is Daniel Snyder, the two worst owners in sports.
The worst. And that nobody wants to play for the guy.
No.
And so, I mean, that's the Knicks are going to be shit for a long time until you get rid of that guy.
Agreed.
He's kicking fans out of these guys are turd on wheels.
Totally.
Anyway, so, but just going back to Bane real quick. That's. Not that Bane, Cody. Darth Bane. Would you want to see a series? If it was the series that from that book.
Yeah.
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 I agree. Totally. That sounds awesome.
Yeah.
Really
just kidding.
Does.
Yeah.
I know. I wish it was easy. And he would be so perfect, Kevin Durant. All right. Moving on, Riley. Let's get to the main stuff.
Okay.
Hollywood put a report.
Right.
Out.
There was a report that came out that Sony was basically hitting the pause button on the Masters of the Universe reboot, and that some outlets picked it up, comicbook.com being one of them, and then the report was pretty much debunked by Sony.
By Sony, right?
Sony itself, comicbook.com, reached out and said, hey, and they said, nope, everything
what
is still moving
report?
Forward.
It was that it was on pause. It was that they were going to stop development on it for now.
But there was a little bit more to it in that report, too. It was from the report had said that the reason why is because they said it was too expensive.
Right.
That there was, they didn't know if the franchise would be able to carry on, if enough people cared about it.
It's realizing the world of Eternia that are having problems because of budgetary stuff.
Obviously, you do not know the answer to this, but just off your gut, do you think this report is true?
I think that there's parts of the report that are true. I think that if Sony says it's still happening, well, then that part of the report is not true. If Sony says we're still going to this movie's still happening in 2022, that is inaccurate. Well, then it's inaccurate. When I spoke to David Goyer at the Vader Immortal, I asked him about his He-Man, the Masters of the Universe version. He was very happy with it. He loved what he'd come up with and what they had come up with. But he said that basically the studio just didn't want to spend the money that it cost to make Eternia happen. So when this report came out, I said that's very similar to what Goyer told me about his version. Mm-hmm. Now, it's not to say that they didn't say the same thing, but my personal opinion is I don't know, and I could be 100% wrong on this. I got to talk to the actual studio heads. I don't think that the people in charge, and this is the same thing I saw when I was at Warner Brothers, I don't think they understand the property. Mm-hmm. I think that they know they have an IP, and that's all they have. They think they have an IP that they think they could turn into something. Hopefully we get the right creator, but they don't know it themselves. They, like they said, they're like, oh, well, maybe we can do it like Thor Ragnarok. If we do it like Thor Ragnarok, because Thor Ragnarok was popular.
And Guardians of the Galaxy.
So let's do it like that. And the fans like that, so we'll do that. As opposed to what you could really do with the actual property. And this is what Goyer was doing also. And originally, I didn't think he was doing this. He was doing Star Wars meets Lord of the Rings, which is what I wanted to do. And what he and I were working on, you know, and what Warner Brothers originally had taken on, and then they just switched it all up. Mm-hmm. But I think that there's some stuff that they – and, you know, you got this unknown kid who's playing He-Man, so there's probably some nervousness there. It's not a proven IP.
It's the guy
IP.
From the Netflix movies, right, that I've been seeing?
Yeah. And so when they look at it, they probably – and some, this is what a lot of people say. When you bring up He-Man
– Oh, no, Centeno.
Yeah. When you bring up He-Man, people think of the 80s cartoon. Like, even in the picture, they bring up the 80s cartoon, and you think of the silly kind of – and I love this. I love the 80s cartoon, but it's silly. And it's campy, and it's cheesy, and that's what they think of it. But they don't go back to the original comic, which was based off Conan the Barbarian, and that type of tone. And then the series that came out in 2002, I think it was, on Cartoon Network, which really got into the lore. And there was some silly shit going on in that too. But for the most part, the lore was great.
I don't think
great.
I ever watched it in 2002.
It was not a lot of people did, but it's great. Mm. So I don't know. I just don't know how much.
Would they dye his hair like a little blonder, you think?
They're going to have to.
Yeah.
Back to him, he's in the new Charlie's Angels movie?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was in that trailer.
Yeah.
Yeah, we saw him in that trailer.
What Netflix movie did you say he was in?
I saw him in two different Netflix movies, so I literally don't remember, but I know that I saw him in two.
He was in all the boys I Love Before.
Oh. No, and Sierra Burgess is a Loser. Yeah.
All the Boys I Love Before was really well done.
Sierra Burgess is a Loser is a very fun watch.
Well, but he's been saying he's been getting jacked up. He's trying to get more in shape, and he's 6'1", so 6'1" on film looks pretty damn tall.
I mean, dude, Zac Efron was never jacked, and then all of a sudden he come up in Baywatch, and you're like, holy jeez. Yeah.
Where did they put him? I haven't seen him.
I don't know why we get rid of him. He's the only one that I understand why we get rid of, because when you have the curtains up, you can't put all this stuff on. I don't know why we get rid of Efron. Mm.
I don't mind that he's not in this room. I just miss his presence in this whole office.
Mm. Why you don't mind him that he's gone?
No, I don't.
Why? You thought it was awkward with the guests?
Mm-hmm.
I loved that part of it.
I don't think it was awkward. I just thought...
I caught myself looking at his abs way too often.
Yeah.
It was unnecessary.
Yeah, I'm with Rocks. It's just a thing. It was like
just pull up pictures of
his personality.
Put him in the
it just looked messy.
Mm-hmm. He had a messy haircut.
I know, and that was.
Don't
messy.
You think Zac Efron would have been?
I would
have
liked if we just had Zac Efron. Yeah. Okay.
Don't you think? Hair is a silliness.
It was messy.
You know what I realize about you?
Yeah, I'm not silly.
I don't think so.
Oh, I am silly.
I don't think so. Mm. You don't like nonsense.
I like nonsense.
I don't.
What you think? I don't. After doing this show, you don't think I like nonsense?
You seem very no nonsense right now.
I'm going to take an honest vote. Would we say that Roxy likes nonsense? Raise your hand if you think she likes nonsense.
How many times do I move the show to nonsense? That's like the whole thing about me that these people say.
Is it nonsense or is it just off questioning? And
that's not nonsense.
You don't like to go along with bits.
Yeah.
That's a no nonsense.
All right.
That's
the bring one. Bring it on, guys. Bring it on.
I would say that. No. We don't want to. It's not. Okay, it's call
ahead.
It a conversation.
No. Here's the thing. You guys are all. What you have to remember is you guys are all men of a similar age with a similar sense of humor. Right. And yes. I have a different sense of humor as a younger woman. So it's not that I don't like to go along with bits in general. It's that I'm not in on your guys' bits.
I'll throw.
Why wouldn't you jump in on the Tucci bit?
I don't feel comfortable doing it.
I want to throw back. I want to throw back just a little bit there. Not because you don't have a different sense of humor. That's a fair point. Because Kate or Dorina the other day, and not to compare them to you, but they're still women. They were back on some back and forth. So that's not fair.
I'm not saying it's just because I'm a woman. Okay. I'm just saying I have a different reference point.
And
I have a different
fair.
Like if you guys want to make Lizzo jokes, I'm here to make Lizzo jokes.
Right.
Okay.
But just for so many different reasons, in the Stanley Tucci one, I'm like. Well, obviously, I've seen Stanley Tucci movies, but I'm like, what does it even sound like? What's happening right now? Like, I don't understand it.
Right.
Okay.
Not that I don't understand it. I understand it, but it's funnier if I don't try to chime in with, like, my Stanley Tucci.
You make such a fair point to where it's like, if it's not your sense of humor, then you shouldn't want to do it. I just don't want to, because like, you guys are dudes and it's dude humor. Because
no.
I guess you can do Stanley Tucci with anybody.
No,
bring
I'm not
in some
saying...
hot Lizzo bits because I'd like to try them.
I want to see a Lizzo versus
Lizzo versus the Tooch.
What would you do with Lizzo? Yeah.
What is the Lizzo bit?
She's too queen to make fun of.
What
actually?
The Blu-ray.
I'm just trying to
what time
get your attention.
10:20.
Oh, we got to do it.
Yeah.
All right. We'll
trying to keep us on track here.
We'll get back to this, but we didn't really get into the Masters of the Universe thing.
I know. We can finish that.
The point
he
is.
He doesn't want to do the bit. Who just ruined the bit now? Thank you.
I did. I had to.
You had to. But
yeah.
Masters.
I have to.
But Masters of the Universe, really quick though, too, because I liked your question as far as like what do I think that a lot of these reports
That's
are
true.
And I think the budget stuff is true because it's the second or third time we've heard something like that inside of this because I don't believe that they know what they have. What do you think?
I think that sometimes these properties get like a stink on them and then they just can't figure out how the F to do it. And so I'm sure where there's smoke, there's fire. There's obvious issues going on here.
Where there's stink, there's shit.
It's been happening
over and
how
over.
How long?
Right.
From studio to studio. It even started back when we got the script from John Woo. Like, they didn't know what to do with it back then. When was that? That was 2003?
Give or take. No. It was 2006. 2005,
really?
2006. Yeah.
9?
It just sounds like it shouldn't be as hard as it is.
Yes.
Right. Well, because they don't know what it is. It's because it's, look, we go back to Tony Khan, who runs AEW, right? One of the reasons why WCW didn't work and didn't continue to work because the executives in charge were not wrestling fans. Vince McMahon is a wrestling fan. Okay, the people who work for him are wrestling fans as much so too, right? The guy Eric Bischoff, who was running it, was a fan, but the guys ahead of him in WCW, not fans. Exactly. Tony Khan, who's the executive of AEW, is a wrestling fan. So you have not that means necessarily that it's a slam dunk that product is going to work, but what it means is that it's easier conversations to have the direction of where the product is going, as opposed to saying to someone like, "Are you Masters of the Universe fans?" No, but we think it could be like Thor Ragnarok. That's
right.
Challenging
because
then you got to say, okay, but if you want it to be like Thor Ragnarok, we got to make Eternia big and we want to have this. Well, that's too expensive.
But it's almost like if they had in 2005 done that, I mean, they wouldn't have had Thor Ragnarok to reference, but that kind of thing, and it had been a stinker, then at this point we could have gone the complete opposite direction. But because they keep delaying, they don't know what they want to do. It's kind of just like make a decision, go in that direction, make the best version of that you can. If it sucks, then in 10 years, try another one.
Yeah, and their biggest thing is the execs look at it and they go, shit, this is for this movie. If Men in Black, which has a name, which has a big name and costs almost $200 million to make, and that bombed, He-Man's going to be terrible. We can't spend $175 million on He-Man. It's like trust in what you have, not what you think because of past numbers and past data. You got to trust in the actual story and the creator you hired to direct it.
They don't do that.
They've never done that.
But also, as being like the devil's advocate here, this movie is not for – they need a younger audience for He-Man, and I don't think you're going to get it.
But also, and this is not a slight at you, but that is probably a lot of the studio thought there. It's like, why is someone going to go and why are they going to respond to some 80s cartoon with a guy with a Dutch boy haircut? And because it's the trailer. It's the conversation. It's like, once again, the fans who are going out to watch Star Wars and these types of movies, because the Thor Ragnarok point is because of your point. Mm-hmm. They want to take the younger, because right now you would say that Marvel, the MCU, is bigger to kids in like the anywhere from like 10 to 15 years old, right? That's bigger than Star Wars is. Star Wars was our thing when we were growing up, and it's certainly for kids now too. I'm just saying the champion, the America's pastime as far as big popcorn movies, that's Marvel. They've got the title. Yeah. So when you take that type of you want to make sure you get that audience, right? Mm-hmm. So you're going to say, well, we'll make it like Thor Ragnarok. But if you take that audience and you train them to say, okay, listen, that's a fantasy movie. That's a science fiction movie. This is a brand new thing that we're going to do. And you give it good lore and you make it look cool. The same way that you didn't necessarily know anything about Darth Bane. But I pitched it in a way to where you said, to your senses.
It does have a Star Wars.
It's got Star Wars background. But it does have Star Wars background, too. It's got the Star Wars name. But you can still pitch that particular storyline, too. It's all on how it's pitched. It's all on how it looks.
I get it, man. But still, the casual fan, you're a diehard. You're a diehard. I'm a casual fan. My brother, diehard He-Man fan, right? That we are an aging culture. We're like an aging breed. And he would have to be like, Luke, my little nephew, come to see He-Man with me. And
Masters of the Universe.
Masters of the Universe.
But who knew Guardians?
Yeah.
Who knew what Guardians?
Yeah, the Guardians was still the Marvel name.
Yeah, it's still the Marvel name on it, too. But it's one of those things that it's just, you want it. It really is about that trailer. Because if the trailer itself looks silly.
As soon as he raises a sword and says, cool. I have the power, and it looks shitty.
It's got to look cool. And I think in our version and in the actual 2002 version of the comic, they find the sword. They find the sword that's been buried for so long.
Mm-hmm. They've been looking for it for many years.
Because it was tradition to where there were He-Man or those types of guardians for thousands and thousands of years.
That sword was passed down like mantle to mantle.
And so this guy, this prince who has like these responsibilities, he's not as much of a dope as him. He doesn't have like a lot of responsibilities, and he likes
his naps under the tree and fishing.
And he finds it,
Arthur.
And he finds it, and it's exactly that Arthur thing. But when he picks it up, he gets the mantle because it's inside of him. It takes the true nature of someone's soul and shows what he could be and the potential. And
it's like the Phantom with Billy Zane. And I bring it up, but it's a good movie.
But Skeletor was the king's. He was the king's brother, I think, in the 2002 version. And but he was possessed by powers, possessed by one of the swords, and he would conform into Skeletor. So there's a lot that you could do with it. But anyway, that's anytime we talk about He-Man, we go down the rabbit hole.
Yeah, you sure do. You have a passion for it, man.
Yeah. So it's a great mythology. Any other stories that we should talk about? Or should we get into these giveaways?
No, I think we hit much. I mean, we could talk about there is the first look at the Witcher series with Henry Cavill. They launched the Netflix series. They've launched the social media campaign.
They're just images.
Yeah, they're images. It's the first look.
And it looked fine.
Okay. They look great.
All right. Well, let's get to this. So this is what we're going to do. Tell us about exactly what we're giving away to the fans. All right. We're going to open up the phone lines
right now. We have three Blu-rays.
Okay.
Two, they're double disc, remastered, 25th anniversary. There's a lot of special features on this. Trailers. There's commentary by Robert Zemeckis. There's The Art of the Screenplay Adaptation, Little Forrest, An Evening with Forrest Gump. Through the Ears of Forrest Gump, which is the sound design. We have the visual effects, the screen tests of everybody joining us.
Totally
so
cool.
It's a big
test.
It's
see
a
that.
Big, beautiful Blu-ray celebrating the fact that 25 years later
best
we got Forrest
Gump. Right?
Yeah, it's a Best Picture winner. And thank you to Paramount for this giveaway. Yeah, we're going to give away three.
All right, so here's what you got to do in order to win. So both Makuga and Riley had come up with these questions very similar to last time. I don't know why, I just got a craving for chocolate. Sorry, Makuga.
I
got a craving. I don't know why.
I love chocolate.
So you're going to call in. We're going to have questions regarding Collider Live, the show. Only call in if you know the show inside and out, because we will hang up on you if you get it wrong. And we're going to then
ask
for the next
question.
You got to get two right
to get
the Blu-ray. So there you go. So you got to get two questions right in order to get the Blu-ray.
And I'll keep asking that first question until we get someone in.
Right. Unless it's Googleable.
Correct.
Googleable. All right, let's get to the first caller. Hey, you're on Collider Live. Who do we got? Hey, you're on Collider Live.
This is Brad from Nebraska.
Brad from Nebraska. All right, Brad. So you got a chance here to win this ultimate Blu-ray from Forrest Gump. You think you know the show well enough?
Yeah.
All right. All right. Here we go. Yeah. Two questions. I like the all confidence on Brad.
Here you go, Brad. Christian has an ongoing feud slash battle in his backyard area with what kind of woodland creature?
A squirrel.
That is correct.
Duh, Josh. Duh.
Would have also accepted raccoons, even though they're not woodland creatures.
Okay. Yeah. Last week on the show, on Thursday, I believe, what kind of, I'm going to keep this in the theme, what kind of furry rodent did myself, Riley, and Christian riff about last week?
A mouse.
That is correct.
Look at the big breath. Look, big brown breath.
Big brown breath.
Big
Brad. Do you have a Twitter?
Brad is rad. That is true.
Brad, do you have Twitter?
Yes, I do.
Okay, please hit me up on Twitter. Just, you know, tag me or something. I'll follow you, and we'll I'll DM you, and we'll get your details.
There you go, Brad. Coming out of the gate strong here.
Like Brad.
All right.
Well done.
So Brad comes out, gets the first
one copy down.
All right. Two left. Two left. All right. Let's see who's gonna make these a little harder here.
Yeah.
All right. Getting on Collider Live. Who you got? You.
Hello.
Hello. What's happening with the phone lines? Is anybody there?
They hung up.
Oh. They panicked.
Is that the first?
Total panic.
Bum, 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 bum.
Your boss called.
Right. Hey, you're on Collider Live. Who do we got?
Tommy from New Jersey.
Tommy.
Hey, Tommy.
Tommy, first question. Make
I used to
sure
hook up
gonna...
with a guy named Tommy from New Jersey.
From New Jersey? Yeah, maybe the same guy. So,
I don't think so.
Here's the first question that is...
Tommy, have you hooked up with Roxy?
It's an easy question. It's an easy question. August 31st, we will be in New York for the Schmodown in Manhattan. Will you be there?
Yes, I will be.
All right. Good answer.
Hey, Tommy. Big fan of the Dooch.
All right, here we go. Two questions for you, Tommy.
All right. complete this sentence. It's an illusion.
Fuck you. It's an illusion.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. There it is.
Okay. All right.
Fuck you.
It's an illusion. All right, Tommy. What did Roxy get the biggest laugh out of between Riley and Christian 2 weeks ago?
So good.
The little hand slap.
Yeah,
that's my humor. Also, I'll do that bit.
I would have also accepted Twitter response to Bill Cosby.
Yeah, Twitter response to Bill Cosby.
I would have gotten that too. Read the room, Bill.
Give Tommy, who's going to be in New York at the Schmodown, a big fan of the Tooch, give a Blu-ray.
Hey, Tommy, are you on Twitter?
Yes, sir.
All right. Hit me up on Twitter at Riley Around, and I'll get you that Forrest Gump 25th anniversary.
Listen to this. So two for two. We have three for three here giving away? I mean, look, people want these Forrest Gump Blu-rays because they are firing out all cylinders here.
I came out a little bit there.
Who's it?
Forrest.
What are you going to do?
Forrest Gump.
Forrest Gump.
You know also
Forrest has it? Hills.
The fucking Tooch.
Hey! The Tooch.
The Tooch. Tooch. He came in. He likes to run. He goes, run, Forrest, you fucking run.
What I tell you, Forrest, you fucking run.
You run, you little prick.
You know what they say. Me and Jenny like peas and fucking carrots.
So that's right. We like those fucking
they
carrots.
They like the carrots.
They like them.
They put them with the peas.
And you eat them up.
And they're fucking good.
They're fucking Tooch.
The Tooch.
All right. Yeah. Hey, you're on Collider Live. Who do we got?
Tyler from Tennessee. What's up?
What's up, Alex? All right. You ready for these two questions?
We'll find out.
All right. Here we go.
Good answer.
Jeff? No, it's not Jeff.
Carl from Tennessee?
Alex.
Okay.
Hey, Alex.
Tyler.
Why do people think it was Alex?
I don't know. I just thought
it's
Alex.
Tyler, you doofuses. Yeah.
Sorry, Tyler.
Here we go. What town?
Willie the Bull.
That was good.
What town in Alabama is Forrest Gump from?
Greenbow, Alabama.
Yeah!
Oh,
Alabama! I think you should go back to Greenbow, Alabama.
Tyler, because we messed up your name, I'm going to give you an option. Would you like another Forrest Gump question, or would you like a Collider Live question?
Give me Collider Live.
Okay.
All right, Tyler.
I like the skills.
Carl, Alex.
Riley has brought up this story a couple times in the show. It's about Jeff Goldblum. Now, outside of what pharmacy chain was Jeff Goldblum wandering around in Los Angeles?
It's a good one. It's hard.
I think I know it. It's a tough one.
It's a tough one. I want to give him one more.
Can I go back to Forrest Gump?
No. Give him an easier Collider.
Was it Rite Aid?
Yes.
It was Rite Aid. Yeah. Give him another one.
Right,
give
sorry,
give him another Collider Live, though, because he opted to take it. I want to give him one more.
Okay. Here we go. What candy didn't Roxy know wasn't chocolate?
That's an easy one.
Is it?
Did you listen last week? If you listened last
week,
it was a big
time.
I've
gotten a lot of tweets about this.
I
was gone last week. I wasn't able to listen.
Sorry, Tyler.
Take a guess.
Can we get a hint?
Take a guess.
Take a guess.
Yeah. What,
tell me the question again.
Okay, here you go. What candy didn't Roxy know wasn't chocolate? It's in there. No hints.
We could do one hint and it would give it away.
Yeah.
Five.
Kit Kat.
Kit Kat.
Fuck you, Tyler. I didn't know Kit Kats. What?
All right. Let's bring. Do another caller. Sorry, Tyler.
Tyler. You got to tell them the answer to that one.
No. The next person.
All right.
We don't have a ton of.
All right. Hey, you're on Caller Live. What do we got?
Hi, this is Adrian from Phoenix.
Hey, buddy. All right. So can you answer the previous question?
Hey, Adrian.
Or do you want it again?
Can you remind me, sure I caught it?
Sure.
My screen might be a little off.
Okay. What candy didn't Roxy know wasn't chocolate?
Reese's Pieces.
Yes!
All right, last question.
Thank you, friend. Thank you. Kit Kat my ass.
I'm going to ask you a Forrest Gump question. Okay. Here you go. What kind of party did Forrest Gump ruin when he punched Jenny's boyfriend in Washington, D.C.
That's good.
Oh, my gosh.
We've said it on the show multiple times. Yes. It's one of Riley's nice favorite things to say.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know the answer.
What kind of party? And what was that?
I think I know.
It's one of Riley's favorite.
Yeah. What kind of party did Forrest Gump ruin when he punched Jenny's boyfriend in Washington, D.C.? It was after he got the Congressional Medal of Freedom and their Congressional Medal of Honor, and then they met in the pool outside D.C.
Oh, my gosh.
They were at a party.
It's been too long. Let me just, I guess, take a guess. A Halloween party.
We were looking for Sarooge, a Black Panther party. We wanted to see it.
I just love that line.
We have more questions.
Sarooge,
a Black Panther party.
Thanks for calling.
All right, so we got one more copy here of the Forrest Gump. All right, hey, you're on Collider Live. Who do we got?
Hey, how's it going? It's Alan from Florida.
Hey, Alex. Hey. All right, so you're going to get two questions here. Here we go.
Is it Alan or Alex?
Alan.
Alan.
Okay, Alan. Hey, Alan.
I really want to call everybody Alex today.
Yeah. Alan, if you've been...
No, it's not Alex.
Alan, if you've been watching this entire show,
Alan.
You know at the beginning of the show, I said Roxy looked like a combo of these two Lord of the Rings characters.
Want to say that again?
Okay, if you've been listening to this show, this current show that we're on right now, this episode, at the beginning of the show, I said Roxy looked like a combo of these two Lord of the Ring characters.
Oh, my God. You got me there.
Just guess.
There's only like five Lord of the Rings.
You've seen Lord of the Rings.
And not character, but like kind of
species.
Categories?
Species. Yeah.
Oh, Hobbit.
And?
Oh, my God.
Be careful.
All we can remember is Hobbit. It doesn't bode well for me.
That's all I remember.
You know, just go through the races of characters.
I would guess another one. Here you go. I'm going to give you a five count.
Oh,
five.
An elf.
Yeah! There's one.
All right. Thanks, Alan. Good
short,
reminder.
Short as a hobbit, lovely, beautiful
hobbit?
As an elf.
Yes.
All right, next one. Okay.
All right. I'm going to give you a Forrest Gump question. You ready?
Oh, boy.
What did Forrest Gump name his shrimping boats?
Come on.
What did Forrest Gump what?
Name his shrimping boats, like his shrimp boats, the boats that he caught shrimp on.
Five.
Probably his favorite name.
Four.
They're all over LA.
Hold on.
Three. Two.
Wait, hold on. I'm sorry. Say that again because you're breaking up.
Last one.
Last. What did Forrest Gump name his shrimp boats?
Five.
Name his shrimp boats.
Four. Three. Two.
Yeah, I don't have it.
All
right, sorry. Thanks, Alan/Alex.
All right, we're going to give one more phone call here.
I knew I was a hop, but I didn't know.
All right, so here we go. So final call here today. You are on Collider Live. Who do we got?
Hey, guys. This is Kevin X from Sacramento.
What's up, dude?
All right, so you got two questions here. See if you can get it.
All right, you ready? What did Forrest Gump name his shrimp boat?
Who's he in love with?
He really loves this.
I thought it was something
you
else.
You thought it was something else. Yeah. You were thinking of the restaurant.
It's his favorite name.
Is that not what the boat's called?
Andy Curran?
Think about who he was in love with the whole fucking movie.
Well, he just said.
Did he say it?
Yeah, he said the full name.
Yeah.
Wait, what did you say?
He said Jenny.
Jenny.
Okay, we'll give you Jenny.
Yeah.
Thank God.
All right.
Okay. All right, last name
now
too.
You get now you get a Collider Live question.
I thought it was called
this
Bubba.
Is actually a Schmodown question, but what was the one item Alex stocked the craft service table with during a recent Schmodown event?
I love you, Alex, but chips.
Yes.
All right, good. All right, so you got it.
All right, you go on Twitter. Can you hit me up on Twitter?
Hit Riley up on Twitter. He will get it to you. And, guys, that's the show. Thank you so much today for joining us. Hell of a show. A lot of fun. And tomorrow, do we have a guest tomorrow?
Let me look. I believe
Who do we have tomorrow?
We have Devin Sawa.
Oh,
Devin
big kind of funny.
Yeah, okay, for he's going to be promoting the Escape Plan 2.
Okay, cool.
And his time Devin with Sly. Yeah.
Awesome. So
and
that's
the director as well is going to be joining us, both of them.
Oh, that's cool. So tomorrow, check that out for sure. Like I said, if you haven't already gotten tickets for Comic-Con, theschmodownlive.com, make sure you do that. And check out the comic book shopping tomorrow with Jake Gyllenhaal. It drops tomorrow. It'll be on the main channel of Collider before the show even goes on. Thank you to Roxy Stryer, Mark Riley, Josh McCuga, Hey Alex, and Cody Hall. See you guys tomorrow.
Open the public.